It's more fun to be there live to see the Memphis Grizzlies hit the court all season long. From the electricity in FedEx Forum to the highlight reel plays, there's nothing quite like Grizzlies basketball. As the official marketplace of the Memphis Grizzlies, Ticketmaster gets you in with a huge selection of seats. So get off the couch and into the stands while you still can. Score tickets today at Ticketmaster.com. That's Ticketmaster.com.
Elevate your hotel experience in the heart of downtown Memphis at the Westin Memphis Beale Street. Our AAA Four Diamond Hotel boasts spacious guest rooms and suites, refreshed meeting space, upscale dining, and more. Just steps away from the sights and sounds of Beale Street, FedEx Forum, and the Memphis Rock and Soul Museum. After a full day of work or play, retreat to your hotel room or suite featuring luxury bedding, a contemporary bathroom, a spacious workstation, complimentary coffee, and a flat-screen TV. During downtime, you can take advantage of perks such as our on-site fitness center, 24-hour business center, and upscale dining at Penny's Nitty Gritty. On your next visit to downtown Memphis, make the Westin Memphis Beale Street Hotel your home away from home.
Let's face it, there's a lot of trash talk in basketball, but the great teams let their performance do the talking. Like Ford F-150 with Pro Power Onboard, a class-exclusive industry-first feature that turns your truck into a mobile generator and leaves the competition speechless. Ford F-150, official truck of the Grizzlies. Greatness starts here at your Mid-South Ford dealer. Class is full-size pickups under 8,500 pounds, GBWR.
Grizzlies fans know it's the team that gives you the edge. Big River Steel does too. That's why we're looking for team members to help us reshape the steel industry for a more sustainable tomorrow. Our edge starts with you. At www.BigRiverSteel.com/join to join our Dash team. That's www.BigRiverSteel.com/join to join our Dash team.
Live from downtown Memphis, this is the Chris Vernon Show, presented by Caesars Sportsbook on YouTube at Grind City Media and the official Grind City Media app. Now, here's your host, Chris Vernon.
Noon on GrindCityMedia.com. It's Chris Vernon Show. Welcome, 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 welcome. It is the Monday, April 15th, 2024 edition of the show. Today on the show, we got 10 things from the weekend. It was a busy weekend. Grizzlies just had their season-ending media day as everybody says goodbye. And the Grizzlies season ended with a game against Denver yesterday at FedEx Forum. We'll talk about that. We'll talk about what was said at the closing media day. The playoffs are set, except for the 1 and 2 seeds in both conferences and who they will play in the play-ins. But the play-in tournament is set as well. We'll get to that. The Masters took place over the weekend, and Scottie Scheffler won that for a second time. We'll get to that. We'll get some Memphis basketball news. We'll tell you what's going on tonight. May have a surprise on the show today. Who knows? It is a Monday. It is beautiful outside. Smile. Let's do it. Turn it up! Hope everybody's having a good day. All right, we have a ton of stuff to get to, and it has been a busy last 24 hours around FedEx Forum, as yesterday the Grizzlies had their final game of the season against the Denver Nuggets, which did have something interesting happen within it. A record was broken yesterday that you may or may not know about. In addition to that, Everybody says goodbye this morning as their season is over, as the rest of the NBA will continue with the play-in tournament and then the playoffs after that. Before I get to anything, welcome John Roser to the show. John Roser, a.k.a. the Cologne Ranger, the Body Spray Band at Senior Sack, a.k.a. Gender Back Bullet, Gender Bearcat, a.k.a. the Grim Roser, John Asparagus, Johnny Nick Harb, John Lance, John Pistol, John Garabalo. He is Yogi Roser.
What up?
Hello, John.
Hello.
Devin Walker's here. He is the microphone mangler, Senor Quasadilla, Mr. Man, Navajo Joe, the reporter, the photographer. He's Sir Hiss. Sun's out, guns out.
Yeah, bro, it's off season, bro. We here, bro. Shout out to my Sting cut off from rocking today. Shout out to my guy sending this to me. Shout out.
Kelsey Rye Johnson is here. She is Brampton's finest. She is the Nordstrom Rack trap queen. She is Puerto Rico's favorite reporter. She is the ketchup chip connoisseur.
If you just cut that, if you screen grab that, with your lower third on it.
I look very naked.
Let's see.
Go back to her and put the lower third up.
Oh,
she looks like she's not wearing clothes. Topless Kelsey on the show.
Views.
Yeah, views. Like, she's what?
Everybody text your buddies. All right, let's get to 10 things.
I love 10 things.
We know.
They say you look like a 2000s blogger. You dress like a 2000s blogger.
Oh, I can see it. Now that
me?
Said it, yeah.
Yeah, like you like blogs in like the 2000s.
Yeah, it's the denim shirt and the hat.
Like you wrote for Deadspin in the 2000s.
Like I'm in a Brooklyn coffee shop?
Yes, bro.
I'm in a Brooklyn coffee
shop. You're a Brooklyn coffee shop.
Filing my post?
Yes.
Maybe I am.
Either that or like the spoken word rapper. You got the common hat.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you got the those.
No, I think it needs to be like more flat, yeah. Like a train conductor.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah.
I need
yeah.
one of those hats if I'm going to be spoken word.
Yeah, but no, you do it like.
The Grizzly season ended yesterday. But everything is not over.
Okay. Come on, finish it. It has a rhyme.
Hopefully when we get to the draft, they'll be lucky as a four-leaf clover.
Oh!
Bars!
Let's go.
That's
bars!
That's great. Shout out to you.
Bars!
That was a good one.
All right. Number one! The season ended yesterday. They played against the Denver Nuggets. Womp womp. And a record was broken yesterday. Do you guys know what record was broken yesterday?
I think I do know.
All right. I mentioned it in the post-game show, but I had to look it up on my phone because I was like, once we started talking about it, I'm like, there's no way that's ever happened before.
I checked my email, so I think I know.
What?
I think our boy sent us a whole rundown.
What record?
Was it the lineup record?
No.
It wasn't that?
GG. That might be so.
GG, franchise points by a rookie, most points in a game by a rookie.
That might be. I don't know.
That one's true.
It is true?
Yeah. We used
so I'm not wrong.
Oh, actually, my record is the Grizzlies use an NBA record 51 different starting lineups.
Okay.
So that was a legitimate
record. Oh, there was more records than I knew.
Yeah,
lots
bro.
Of
51 different starting lineups for the Grizzlies.
How about this one?
What's yours?
No one.
Uh-huh.
I always tell you, when you go to a game, you might see something you've never seen before. No one in the history of the Memphis Grizzlies franchise going back to Vancouver. Because, you know, you can always get the stats and they'll include like Sharif Abdul-Rahim or Greg Anthony or Anthony Peeler or somebody like that. No one has ever taken more shots in a basketball game than G.G. Jackson took yesterday.
Yay,
G.G. Yeah, get him up.
I saw the attempts number. I'm like, there's no way somebody's taking 36
Gigi.
Shots. He broke Ja Morant's record.
Really?
What was Ja?
34.
Get him up, G.G.
31.
He was trying to get
that's last game of the season.
Yeah,
stuff,
he was trying
right?
to get that 50 ball, bro.
Almost. He almost hit that that last three he took, I thought, mm-hmm. was going down. That would have gotten him to 47.
I wish he would have made the three when he made, who was that, Percy Watson, what was his name?
Oh,
is?
My God.
He made him buckle twice. He hit him with the in and out. Then he buckled, then the cross-up. I was like, please make the three. He missed mm-hmm. it. But shout out, Gigi, man.
Anyways, you know, look. All
oh,
was.
Gigi.
I see,
oh, Gigi Jackson.
One
silver
Gigi.
Prism.
One little Gigi.
Look at him.
Just came in the mail this morning.
That's
get
so
Roser.
Cool.
Look at the Gigi. It's for sale.
It's Gigi season, baby.
He said it's for sale if anybody wants it.
They go for like $180, $200.
Oh, okay.
Oh, why are you trying to sell his
It's Johnny Hustler. You didn't know?
He is my reason.
Now he's trying to sell it on the show.
Same. Hit me up.
You got to do like those guys did in the 90s up. On the Home Shopping Network. Don Best or whatever that guy's name was. Jim Mintan. 10.
Jim meant 10, and as far as
Jim
I know,
meant 10.
As of last week, only 23 of these have been graded a 10.
Oh, somebody knows the pop count.
I know, right? Hey, wait, I'm asking, did he have, so Kenny dropped, what, 50 last year? How many did Kenny have in the
Kenny
last
had
game
40,
last year?
I think
he had 40.
Yeah, 40. 42,
right?
Was the record.
Was it 42? See.
Kenneth Lofton.
I think it was 42.
42 points. Let me see how many shots he took in that Grizzlies. Because you said he took 37?
Versus OKC.
Took 37
36
shots?
36 last night.
Okay, he had... How many did it take Kenneth Lofton to get?
It was on 0409, if you want to look at court
five. Keep talking. I'm going to find it.
Okay.
So also, G.G. Jackson joined this player, the two youngest in NBA history to have 40 or more points and 10 or more rebounds in a game. I will tell you, the other player is active. Is a
LeBron
current player
James?
No, it's not LeBron James.
Giannis Antetokounmpo?
It's not Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Anthony Edwards?
It's not Anthony
Clifford
Edwards.
Clifford Robinson?
Two youngest players to have 40
Is Cliff
plus...
Robinson active?
Oh, someone the one that's not active.
Oh.
There's another Cliff Robinson in the league?
No, you said one is not active, right?
No, I said one. They're, I said the other is
you
active.
They're both active.
He took
25.
He was 17.
Jaren Jackson Jr.
It's not Jaren Jackson Jr.
Who else was like super young when they came into the league? Tracy McGrady.
Tracy Mack.
Not, he's not
Jermaine
active.
Jermaine O'Neal.
Tracy McGrady's not active.
Jermaine O'Neal.
Yeah, he's not active
not,
either.
Not active either.
Oh, they're not active. Yeah, that's true.
No, they're not active.
Is in the playoffs.
Which conference?
It's in the West. This shouldn't be that difficult.
KD?
Kevin Durant.
No. Oh. All right.
So, Gigi is in good company.
Yeah, all those stats that he broke this record, or all those stats that he accumulated this year, always have those crazy youngest since or the youngest two because, you know, he was a reclass guy.
Yeah.
And so you think about it, and, you know, you remember who was the guy? Was it Oregon that had the player that, like, had the 70 points in the first two games of the tournament, and I came on the next day, and I was like, he is 6 years older than G.G.
Jackson.
Right.
It was
something crazy. Yeah. We looked him up for the draft, and he was, like, 5 or 6 years older, legitimately, than G.G. Jackson. It's like, good grief.
Jermaine Cousinard. Yeah,
is that right?
Yeah, that's him. Yeah, he played at South Carolina, actually, for 3 years.
Oh, okay.
So...
Yeah.
He played 5 years.
Jermaine Cousinard, also a full year older. He's older than Jaren Jackson Jr. So
I will say this. I have been through several 20-something win seasons. This was the most palatable of the 20-something win seasons.
Yeah.
Right? Because I do think there's a couple things that I will give them kudos for, which is you know, we talked about this yesterday on our pregame show when we were talking about the season and kind of silver linings of the season. And one of them is obviously that you found players that you otherwise would not have probably found, right? You know that Vince Williams can be a part of your future and part of the rotation. You know G.G. Jackson can be part of your future, part of the rotation. These are not like going to next season to find. You also had some internal growth from some of the other guys. Laravia looked the best he's ever looked those last 15 games of the season, and you had some other things that took place. You also have good reason for being bad, and that's because you had 30-something players and you had 50-something lineups. But most importantly, once the season was going to go to hell, I respect the fact that they did not just punt completely and try to get the absolute best possible draft pick that they can get. At that moment, you can do the thing where you're just trying to get the most ping pong balls you can possibly get. And it's awful, right? Because what you do is you end up like pulling guys in the fourth quarter that are having good games. And I've been through that as well.
We did that with Gasol in Utah one
year. Yeah, and it's super annoying. It's like you are... And I thought that, like, look, you could say that they intentionally did not put out the best product, but I do think that there was a method to their madness in trying to get a look at as many guys as they possibly could. And once the goal became make us the best possible team for next year... But then whoever did go out and play, they competed. They did. Over and over again, they competed.
Oh, no.
Speaking of competing.
Look who it is.
Look who it is. Hey, buddy.
Yeah. Why are you getting up?
You want to take my seat?
Every.
You don't have to get up.
You want?
No, I'll sit right here.
Come on, grab a microphone.
Come on, just grab it. Come on.
How are y'all? You good?
Let's yeah.
Hi, Jaren.
What's up, Jaren?
Jaren Jackson Jr. is here. Over and over again. They went out there and competed, and I will say that, like, I've been around for a lot of the 20-something win seasons, and during the 20-something win seasons, it can get really, really bleak. But whoever they had out there went out and played hard every night, like all the way to the end, right? Well, we got that Laker game the other night. We got this Denver game yesterday. It wasn't for lack of trying, right? And there's a lot of teams that once they know they're going to be in the lottery, just say to hell with it, and then they just lose everything on purpose and try to get as many lottery balls as they possibly can.
I think, remember one of the earlier years when we were covering the team, it's like they went like back to back to back 22 win seasons, and it was like the next, you're sitting there, it's miserable because you don't see anything on the horizon. Like you're like, what is it next year? Like how are we going to be good again next year? With this, you do see it.
This man right here
should be really freaking good.
You
next
even got Jaren Jackson Jr. playing over 65 games.
What up, chat?
Hey,
you want to talk to the chat? Hey. You got the chat open?
What up, chat?
Yeah, if the chat's open, yeah, go ahead.
Shout out to the chat. How you feeling, bro? You look like the that little meme with the hoodie, the frog.
Oh, no, Kermit.
Little
Kermit meme,
like the Sith Lord.
Oh, you didn't?
So I'm just.
Oh, well, just say hey.
My hair's not, you know.
So oh, that's why you got the hoodie on.
No, that was my vibe.
You look good on the camera.
I'm making a comment that, you know, my hair's not. This is a good little last day.
7 foot tall.
Oh.
You've never done this before.
7 foot tall. Okay. Look at him.
Wow, this is nice. I'm on this side of it. I saw the show in the elevator. So yeah, I was like, let's just pull up.
Why not?
Why not?
Yeah. Right? What'd you have to do? You just had to do the one media thing this morning. I guess you had to have your...
We had workouts. I mean...
Workouts? The season's over.
No, dude. I mean, I haven't. We don't stop.
Really?
None of us, bro. I said it. None of us. None
As of
stop.
Today, no, you guys like, will be back working out.
We've been working out for like weeks.
Wow.
Yeah. Dez is working out right there. Dez is working out right now. Ja works out every day. I work out every day. And if we, you know, if we don't, we get on each other like. That's what kind of.
How much do you guys talk about, like, just being able to play on the court together? Fish had on the pregame show yesterday maybe the craziest stat I can imagine. Do you know how many games you guys have played together?
20.
No. Total. Ever.
25.
You think you?
I don't know.
You think you've only been on the court with
Ja? Maybe it's more, right?
Ja and Bane 25 times? Come on.
Probably like.
It's 103.
Oh, that's not bad.
What are you talking about? It's not bad. You guys have been on the team for 4 years.
Wait, 103 minutes a game?
Something like,
something like
33%. It's like over the last three seasons, they've been on the court together. It's like 33% of the games.
I think the all trick is if we could ever have all three of you guys simultaneously on the court for a long time.
I know everybody wants to see that, so. We're going to give it to him. I mean, you saw the sample size this time, and that was nice. I felt really good about that. I mean, Pelicans game was crazy.
Unbelievable.
That comeback. And Laker game, you know. Different games like that, they stand out, and we'll remember that all summer, but we're not gonna take it for granted either, you know. We're
right.
Strive to be a little bit better.
When you think about this season, what do you think about?
Is it
disappointing to you? Does it make you sad where you think about what might have been? Do you look at it as opportunity going forward? Like, I mean, it's clearly never how you want the season to go.
Yeah, it's like your memory.
It's like it gets ripped away, right?
Yeah. I mean, you just got to, like, make sure you never forget it so you can use that fuel for the next season. I think the season before this was a lot of fuel, too. It's just, you know, some things are out of your control. But you just take every opportunity to get better. And when you see things not shaping out your way, you just kind of look for the positives and look for things you can, you know, bring to the next time. Because, I mean, now we're in a situation where it's like, you know, it's all or nothing next year. You know, that's how we feel. I mean, we felt like that this year, but it's a little bit different. But now it's just like, look, we're all going to be starting from a base, and the goal is this, and anything less is just not okay.
Do you feel like when you say just getting better that you that that is a silver lining. You had the ball in your hands a ton this year. You're a primary scorer and got so much attention from the other teams. Like, there was a different responsibility that was put on you this year that will then, in it may take time, but that you'll look back on and go, oh, wow, I'm glad I got all those opportunities to be the guy, because now look how much easier this is on me when I've got the other two out there.
It was fun. It was a lot of fun. I mean, I'm bringing the ball up off the inbound.
It's like high school, right?
No.
You weren't high school? I mean, the guy with the ball all the time?
I didn't bring it up.
Yeah, no. You was like in the middle, weren't it? Like real like, center. Like,
yeah. Oh, I mean, okay. Our high school team was – number one high school team in the world.
Jordan Poole.
Lalu, yeah. Man. Two L's. Like, I'm saying, like, we were the best team in the world. You do what you do to fit in. I've been on good teams, like, in my whole history, including now, and I do better with good teams. I play better with great players around me. So,
have you ever had the ball in your hands as much as you did this season?
No.
Really?
Not outside of like summer camp when I was like 11.
I literally compare it to that. Like, Michigan State didn't look like that. I didn't bring it up one time. I didn't bring the ball up off the inbound one time except for this season and camp. When I was at like Good Counsel and DeMatha and Good Counsel St. John camp in Maryland.
That's the last time, 11 years old? Shoes.
Yeah, people don't know about those schools. Paul to Six, all them. Yeah.
That's crazy. So you don't look at this, but like, are you sad the season's over? Or were you ready for it to be over?
Am I sad the season's, for sure I'm sad the season's over. I mean,
you are?
Yeah, season's fun, bro. Get to go everywhere, play. Yeah, I'm sad the season's over. Summer's too long, man. It's April 15th.
Yeah, well, are you doing USA?
Coachella's going on, you know?
Coachella, you're not going?
No,
it was, Coachella
like,
was lit.
But we had a chance to go. That's
anybody
what I'm
got a
like,
ticket?
You know what I mean?
Are you playing USA? Are you trying to play USA this summer?
I will.
You will?
They asked me that in media. I was like, what are you talking about? Did you see that?
Or
you
yeah, I saw your reaction. You look like,
just like
you were very confused.
Like, I'm like, and then he was wrong. He was like, yo, you're in the training camp thing. And I'm like, am I? I feel like I would have got a call because I think I know them better than you. And he's like, well, I mean, I saw something. I'm like, well, so you don't really know. Like,
yeah, you know how you know.
Like, oh, you went after a reporter today? Yeah, no. God, I wish I would have been there.
I mean, hey. Well, I mean, Is that the first time you ever snapped back at a reporter? John had to correct somebody, too.
I'm a pretty nice person.
I know.
John had to get on somebody's ass, too, today.
Who? Today?
I mean, but today. Somebody
John did?
Yeah, somebody mentioned like about your growth and stuff like that.
My growth?
Your growth as a player, as a basketball player.
On offense. Come on.
And he was like, you're lucky some Jaren won't yell at y'all or something like that. Y'all are yelling at Jaren, blah, 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 blah. Because we talk about the internet narrative.
Yeah, he said that y'all don't curse anybody.
You're lucky though, yeah, Jaren don't curse y'all out.
Wait, he went after internet trolls?
Yeah, because there's a weird section of like the pocket of the internet that complains about everything you do.
About Jaren?
Yes,
it's Grizz Dark Web.
Jaren Dark Web. Everything, like every step you take, it's like, oh no, why is he walking like that? Oh no, why is he not doing this? Oh no, he scores 40. Why do you score 42? It's like, what? Yeah. What do you want? Like the shot at the Milwaukee, the fader. Oh, why didn't you do this? It's like, all right, okay. All right, bro. Cool. But no, Ja had to, you know, speak on it.
So what was the question?
It was about your offensive growth.
Offensive growth.
Talk about your growth. Ja got mad at the internet. basically what he just asked, you bringing the ball up and like the offense really running through you.
It wasn't even actually about the internet.
It was like, yo, shut up, internet.
Hey, man.
He cooking.
Do you think that you've gotten much better at that, or do you think that it did buy? I can only imagine as a young player, because we even deal with it here, right? Like what the internet says about you. When you're young, it can really overtake you, and you start to feel like, you know, the negativity, I can imagine. And you probably can talk to young players now about it, right? Compartmentalizing and being able to separate what's reality and what's fiction, because you guys get so much feedback all the time. How do you deal with that?
Yeah. I mean, I think it just takes some time. Like, I'm going into year 7. Like,
so when did you stop caring what the internet said?
I mean, when you're a rookie, everything's positive. Like, right. You know, I was getting the GG treatment. Like, you're the youngest to do anything. You're the youngest to walk, to shoot. You're the youngest to be alive. Like, it's so fun. Like, everything you do is, like, so cool. And then when you don't do anything, it's like, oh, it's okay. You wasn't even supposed to do it anyway. Like, it's all good for real. But, I mean, it was a little bit different for me because my class was, like, Luca and Trey, and they were overachieving, like, crazy. They're starting an all-star game after the Rising Stars game. I'm like, we're in the Rising Stars game. I'm like, bro, why are y'all even here? Like, y'all playing on Sunday. And I think I probably stopped caring. I don't know. It just like happened over time. I think I just didn't have enough time to care. And when I went back to having enough time to care, I didn't. I don't know when the exact moment was, but it just takes a minute. Like, I mean,
you gotta build
I'm
it up.
Seven I'm in, like, yeah, like I literally just in, don't. Yeah. I don't think I have it in me to like really care. Like, I don't know. It's becoming an adult, right? We grew up with the internet. Like, yeah. I know how it works. I be on the internet. Like, the internet's funny. Like, you know,
right.
You're just in it now. Like, it's just you're a part of the story. So you're gonna be funny, hated, loved. It's just kind of. I mean, how do y'all feel? I see what they say about y'all all the time.
Well, I bet you do. Yeah. I bet you see.
You say stuff all the time.
Like what?
Like you say, your Twitter is like lethal at times.
Oh yeah.
Every time I'll be on the bus, I'll be like, yo, you see what Devin said? Oh my God.
I think. I'll be like, oh my
God. Which Twitter are you talking about? I have three of them.
For me.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't.
Yeah.
The one with your name on it. Hold on. Let me. I mean, you can explain. I mean, sure.
Yeah. For me. It overtook me when I was young. Like, truly. I was like, this is how people feel? This is how people feel? Like, it drove me crazy. Honestly. It drove me crazy. And I got to the point where I thought this is going to... If I pay attention to this and I allow this to affect me, then... I'm not going to be able to do this job anymore. But I see all the young guys, you know, react to the internet too. Even in the NBA, it's not because look, everybody's got an ego, and so you know the idea that you're not going to care what anybody says about you, that's not true. Of course you're going to care. It's the way everybody's always going to care. It's the way you let it affect you, right? Mhm. So wait, go ahead. You can use the lipstick if you want.
That's don't do that.
Hey,
no, it's, okay,
it's the wave.
It's okay.
We've been waiting for we want you to paint your
fingernails.
No! We want you to paint your fingernails so Devin has to defend it.
No. Jared, no. What is it? Jared, don't. No.
Hey, he's been on Caleb Williams and Jalen Green's ass so much that we're like, please, Jared, paint your fingernails.
Nope.
And the kid from Duke. Who's the kid? From Duke.
He's good. TikTok.
McCain.
McCain. Jared, I got something for you.
No.
You had this season, starting from January on, basically when everybody got hurt except for you, you had 7 games where you had 5 assists or more. Do you know how many times prior to that in your NBA career you have had 5 assists in a game? Twice.
Oh, those. Nice.
Both of them against San Antonio. Once in 2022 and the other in 2020.
Really?
Yeah.
How about that?
What, like,
your playmaking, Jared. Playmaking, yeah, Jared.
Jason Kidd.
Jason Kidd's crazy.
Trip Kidd
is crazy.
Trip Kidd. Oh my God.
Is that like just being comfortable with it? Just like they're double teaming me. I got to pass the ball.
I mean,
what do you think?
A little bit of both.
A little bit of both.
I mean, I had to pass the ball.
Yeah.
I had to start passing the ball. Otherwise, it's just going to look ugly, you know, and then we're going to lose.
Hey, let's talk about the two that you guys found for sure. When did you know Vince could play? When did you know GG could play? And I'm talking about play like these guys are guys that we can have going forward, be rotation guys on a good team. Because I think that's one of the huge storylines that did come out of the season is like, hey, silver lining, you found 2 more players that you might not have found if everybody was healthy because those guys were signed. Mm-hmm. They were probably watching them in South Haven a lot more than in FedEx Forum. And yet, here we are. They both signed contracts, and they're obviously both part of it going forward. When did you see it with both of them? Was it training camp? Was it later than training camp? Was it at some point in the season? Because neither of these two guys knew.
Don't try to blame us.
They're both down at the games with the hustle.
No, no, no,
they're both with the hustle, and neither of them knew. Hating asses.
No, I knew Vince could play.
I knew Vince could hoop. We knew Vince could hoop.
We knew Vince could hoop in summer league. Because every time our summer league team played and Vince played, we were good. And then when he didn't play, we lost.
So, yeah.
That's true.
When did you know that Vince? Because Vince don't talk a lot, though. So, he's still a hoop, but, when did you know he was, that dude? Because he was playing.
At first it was, the defensive assignments. It was me, Dez, and Vince was still out there, and he had all the defense. So I was like, okay, from a defensive perspective, you really do got it. When the stats started coming out, when I started to see the stars really get frustrated game to game, kind of like that DB treatment, it was kind of, I was like, all right, from that. But then offensively, he grew into that, too, Dez went down, and we needed a lot of that.
What's the craziest thing you heard? PG, you've heard him say to somebody, because he talks crazy. He talks crazy, bro.
What's the craziest thing you've heard PG that I've heard? PG is not that crazy, is it?
PG-13. How about that?
Okay.
Because he talks crazy, bro. Crazy.
There's no way. There's no way I'm doing it. I'm not doing it because I'm not talking to y'all. I'm talking to everybody.
Oh, that's true.
And then it's clipped. And then
we don't need you to get aggregated. Yeah,
it's my bad, bro.
Yeah, Legion Hoops. Legion Hoops.
Don't say nothing. That's crazy.
No. When did you know that Gigi? Because there's a thing. Is hey man, he's talented, but he's young, and then he gets his opportunity. Obviously, we have that. He has that huge breakout in the Martin Luther King Day game.
Yeah.
Right. Both of them did actually.
I'm trying to remember the game. I mean, he has breakouts all the time.
You don't remember the Martin Luther King Day game against the Warriors?
It was Draymond's first game back.
They went crazy.
He doesn't remember.
The new Splash Brothers, Vince and Gigi.
My brain's been a little foggy for a couple days. I just been trying.
I understand.
Thank you for your understanding. Gigi's OD, though. He's crazy. Gigi's insane. I told Gigi, man, I told Gigi, I'm low-key hard on Gigi a little bit.
See some of your path with him?
I think he's way better than I was at the same age.
Really? Because you have a weird perspective on him, because you were a reclass guy too, right?
Up?
Yeah. Everybody classes down now. Yeah. You and Gigi.
I just started early. I didn't class up. I didn't reclass.
You were just young for your grade?
Yeah, the whole time.
September birthday, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, September that's it. It's a September
thing. I got you. Yes. Yeah. He reclassed, right, to go up.
Yeah, I turned 19 in that gym.
Right.
I remember that because they brought the band in for me. I remember.
The band?
Yeah, so I was 18. I turned 19. Rizwan? Something, yeah, that was my birthday.
Were they banging on drums?
In the practice gym. It was lit. Happy birthday to me.
Were you happy about it?
I was a little thrown. It was cool, though.
Chris Lyon's a crazy birthday gift.
You think Gigi's a lot better than you were at the same age?
How old is Gigi right now?
19.
Yeah. I mean, the dude did a...
Because you had a double cross
and went by somebody and dunked it. He's pulling it from four-point line. He's right, though. I mean, there was a time in camp when he was he was a little less of what you're seeing, and that's just because his legs were gone because we're doing all this running, and then we got to play. He doesn't know the game isn't gonna be like this, bro. You're not gonna go through a hard practice and play a game. So when the game's out, I mean, he's so skilled. He's a really free spirit. If you've ever talked to him, he should never come on this show.
Why?
If he tries to come
How
on this show,
you?
Do not let him come on here.
Why?
Not until he's I agree. 21.
I agree.
Otherwise, because you're going to be here. You're going to ask him something. He's going to think he's just talking to you. Then he really going to say it. You seen his media?
No, I will say.
It's pretty good. But he borderline, he feels like he's just.
Every game he gets.
So friendly. I'm like, bro, I know, but just
every
know.
Game he gets aggregated. Every game. After these last three games, he's gone viral. Three games in a row.
For sure. We're going to go.
On SportsCenter, House of Highlights.
Don't have him up here. No,
don't worry. They shielded him from me.
He's amazing.
They did. No, when we tried to get him at Summer League, they're like, no.
Yeah, they were. Yeah, it was just absolutely not.
They're like, absolutely. You get Zaire.
That's what they told me. I hope he never. I hope he honestly never changes. Like, you know, someone who has a light like that is super, super rare and special.
Well, you're gonna have to coach him through because he's gone through what you went through at the beginning, which everything is awesome. Everything is praise. Gigi plays drums in the church. Gigi does this. Gigi does that. Everybody loves Gigi. And then by next year, they'll be like, man, he ain't, you know, right?
Yeah, when he when he goes 4-for-13.
You're not the new thing anymore, right?
Yeah. So all that, I mean, they build you up and then they tear you down.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, how do you think you changed? Because I feel like I remember your rookie year. You were like the bouncing around, happy-go-lucky.
I mean,
you still got good energy now, but you are selective as hell with your energy.
Man, you know, I'm older. I'm a little bit busier.
You're like
23, injured.
Somebody said I'm 24.
Older. Yeah, I'll be.
I moved. You know, I have a house now. House maintenance.
That's true.
Homeowners Association.
I have adulting.
Your mom. Adulting. That was what your mom wanted to talk to me about.
What?
She was so proud that not only are you on the Homeowner Association, that you go to the meetings and know, you know, every issue
that's going on
within the neighborhood. I swear to God.
What that mean?
She was like, not only does he go to the meetings, he has researched the issues by the time he goes to the meetings.
Had,
I was like,
we've had speed bump problems. I'm telling you, they put one right by outside my house that actually pissed me off because it's like right before I make that turn, I got like one last one. I'm just like, but it's to stop the hooligans.
The hooligans. There ain't no hooligans in your area, coach.
There's no way. No, bro. Come on, dog. You ain't got no hooligans in your neighborhood.
Really reckless.
You get reckless drivers.
You have no hooligans.
They either have, you know, they're driving around in their nice ranges. Or their AMGs, or their golf carts.
They're going
a little too fast.
The only thing you deal with are people coming up to your door, knocking on your door, trying to give you cookies.
No,
you have had that happen.
I don't mind that.
You don't mind that?
I don't mind that. My neighbors watch this show. Stop.
Oh, they do?
Yeah. What else do they watch?
Oh, my bad. Shout out Jared's neighbors.
Yeah.
Pull up on him. Give him some more cookies. My bad.
First of all, it's this lady. She's very nice. She's down the street.
Shout out to her.
Yes. She's nice. Hey, she's older. She's an elderly lady. Elderly.
Shout out to her.
Shout out to her, man.
She's very kind. She's very nice.
What are the other issues in your neighborhood, Jared?
I mean,
you have zoning issues there.
I live. There's this airplane that flies over my house, like
an airplane.
Yeah, it's like loud. If I'm in my yard, and it goes over, like I'm in the flight pattern, like it's every couple like 10 minutes. Bro, sometimes it's two.
So what are you trying to do to alleviate this?
You
brought it up to the people. You brought it up. Is there anything we can do with that plane
and the pollen?
Oh, the pollen's terrible.
I'm getting whooped.
Yeah, there's nothing you can do about that.
I took a phone call outside the other day because I just needed to take a call. And I'm outside and I'm like, oh, wow. Like, I think I'm getting sick. I told somebody, I think I'm getting sick. And like, I'm sneezing, whatever. I come back inside, I'm okay. I'm rubbing my eyes so much that like, it burning.
Yeah. I've never had allergies either.
Man, this man
until I moved to Memphis. And it's horrible.
I had an early workout today, but I was going to bed anyway. But I like went in my bed. I was like, told my friends, I'm like, bro, I'm going to bed, bro. I can't even like exist out here with y'all. Like, I'm out here like sneezing. I feel horrible. Like, I had to go to bed.
I can't even be near, bro.
Bro,
welcome.
Gotta lower the pollen count in the air.
Lower the
pollen. Hey, chat. What y'all talking about?
No, the chat has a question for you.
Even,
they want you to know. They want to know about like you getting calls like towards the end of the season. You got like a lot of calls. Like,
They want to know about the cookies too. What kind of?
Don't answer that question about the cookies, bro.
Who?
They want to know about the cookies. Don't answer the question about the cookies.
What kind of cookies did you get?
Chocolate chip, right?
Do you feel like you got more calls?
Yeah, you feel like you got more calls towards the end of the season? Because you did go to one game. I feel like you went to the line at least like five positions in a row. You feel like you got you getting.
I mean,
like,
it's tough for a ref, you know? I'm driving hard a lot.
This is spoken like a real NBA PA.
This is a legitimate question, right?
NBA PA.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, come on, bro.
You are a ref.
They're trying really
hard. Hey.
He's media
How about
trained.
This? Come on, bro. Go look. How many times you fell out this year? I think
I got you.
That oh. feels like something.
Oh, let's go!
It feels
let's
like
go!
Some, hey,
hold on, Jared. You, I got you. Hold
that
on.
DPOY.
Hold on.
That helps.
With what?
Fouls? Because now all of a sudden, it was always a narrative. Your first 5 years in the league, how many minutes he can play? Guy's yeah. always in foul trouble. He's got two early fouls.
I mean, to be like, fair,
how many times did you foul out this year?
He fouled out five times. You got three texts too, bro.
You, I'm
three texts.
I mean, yeah.
I got two, oh, I got the one.
All oh, the you
no,
did get
the
tossed.
The tossed was the best. Oh, that was amazing. And Taylor called it effing atrocious.
I mean, it was.
You remember?
Yeah, I know. He went off.
Effing atrocious.
I had to call him that night. I was like, man, I love you, man.
Wait, did you only foul out?
You fouled out twice.
The whole season?
Twice.
Yeah,
this
twice.
Season.
Yeah, twice. DQ twice.
Look at you.
You did foul out in a preseason game.
I bet at that point, y'all were like, oh, God.
Here we go.
No, God. I here went we... home and I'm like, mm-mm.
We haven't even made it to the season yet.
You no, already fouled
no,
out,
this
bro.
This is what you did. It was the last preseason game. So you're like, you're going to make me play the last preseason game. All right. I'm a foul.
Do you notice, like, because I
no,
mean.
No, you know Marcus Smart's going to take all the credit for this, too, right? For the fact that you didn't foul out of any games. Like, yeah, I've been coaching him up. I've been telling him right. Yeah.
I mean, hey, why are you looking at me like I do? I mean, you okay, I see you. You average the same amount of fouls, but you just didn't foul it. You only fouled out one time this year. Two times a whole year.
Playing you, more minutes, right?
Yeah, playing.
Okay. Yeah, play 30, more minutes.
30, four more minutes a game and same amount of fouls.
I saw this happen with T.A. Once yeah. you become that first team all defense, or in your case, DPOY, you get – you get some leniency. Yeah, yeah. Those 50-50 calls start to go your way.
Yeah.
They
I
should.
Mean, shoot. I mess with it. Well, however, I mean, the game is called a very specific way. So it's kind of, it's like, especially if you're a guy like me who's really trying to get to the basket, if you, everything will add up. Like, if you're going for a block and you get a foul, that's probably a good foul because you're trying. But then if you have one that you really shouldn't have gotten because you were frustrated, and then you get a charge, that's three. And then it's like, You got to play a different way. And then you're dealing with Sabonis, and you have three fouls. So he is at an advantage because he knows, you know, he's going to go in your body, hit you with the strongest elbow, pump fake. You know, it's
basketball
just it's different.
Yeah. Do you look at it this year? Obviously, we know how much you love Steve-O and having him next to you. After going through this year and having to play an inordinate amount of minutes at center, do you look at it and go, you know what, man? I'm fine with playing a lot of minutes at center, and maybe that is going to be more of my destiny, and I'll probably play more because it becomes an advantage for us. Or do you look at it go, yo, will you guys please go find a center? It's number two, isn't it?
All right, chat. What's up?
No, go ahead and chat.
Where the chat?
Scroll through the chat.
Say something again.
Scroll through.
KJ, you in your seat?
You
just get over there. Just
you want it.
Chilling.
You want a center.
Type in.
Well, I am KJ.
Jaren wants questions.
Which one? Hey, which center do you want? Just go ahead and tell us who we need to.
Who we need to pipe up? Lift them up.
Let's go ahead and tamper.
David Robinson.
David Robinson.
You probably know him, right? He played with your pops.
I do.
He played with your pops.
That's why it's such a safe answer.
Go ahead and say Tim Duncan too while you're at it.
I would say we might be, if we had prime David Robinson, we might be the best team in the NBA history if you added it.
Hey, that had to be a moment. Hey,
me.
Speaking of your pops, we played on the pregame show yesterday, like season highlights. And the huge game, you know, and the going down to the wire against San Antonio, and then you hugging your dad afterward. That was super cool. Like, it's not all for naught, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, the whole season and everything, and the fact that, like, at least you get that. There were some, like, really cool moments.
What was your favorite one? Favorite memory? I know you, like, try to block out stuff, but, like, what was your favorite memory of the season? Like, your favorite moment?
Honestly, it's not a game I played in.
What game was it?
Milwaukee before All-Star break.
Oh, that
game
the home
was
game.
Awesome.
What happened?
The game was amazing. What are you talking about?
Oh, that was a GG's. That one, okay. Yeah. That was
GG and Zaire.
I was honestly
awesome.
My favorite moment.
Your favorite moment?
Right before
awesome.
All-Star break, we're about to go on vacation. You know, we're going to Turks. You know, I'm flying with Z tomorrow. So I'm like, I'm looking at the game like, man, this will be a great game to like win. And it was crazy.
TNT crazy, too. Bro. TNT
it was
game.
TNT.
TNT game.
And we put that in there. They had to put that in the intro video. That was a good moment.
Yeah. I mean, little things just were interesting. Like, you know, despite everything, like even like Dylan coming back, just seeing Dylan, just like having that weirdness.
Yeah.
Just to, like, have that happen. Just like you're thinking about that in the summer. Like, oh, you know. Maybe. BC coming back.
Hell yeah.
And like how he looked is just crazy, right?
Yeah. Like
it's just,
he looked like OBC.
He
yeah.
does.
Even though
he
I do does, think if yeah. OBC would have got on that break when Wemby's in front of the goal, OBC would have took off.
I mean, bro, Wemby's a different. He hasn't figured him out yet.
Like, yeah, I think OBC would have took off, bro.
He kind of hit him with the float one time.
He
but.
Did.
Let's talk about him. Because you are you are one of these guys that was considered one of these unicorns, right? The kind of guys that are 7 foot tall and you can dribble and you can do everything.
It's about aliens now, buddy.
I know.
It's about aliens now.
When you went out there for the first time on the court and he's out there, like, what was it? Was he what you expected? Was he better than you expected? What stood out?
I mean, like, when he's hitting you with the pull-up three, it's just kind of hard.
He led the NBA in that, by the way, this year. In step-back trays.
Percentage.
46%.
Which is outrageous.
Step-back trays. Luka?
Yeah.
Yes.
46% on step-back trays.
Yeah, I mean, bro, dude's 18 years old, like, looking. He's, like, there's things that he's doing that, like, you've actually never seen, like, at every time, like, of the game. Like, he's stealing a. I threw a skip pass and he stole it from in between. I'm like, I don't like, and then I looked at the bench, like, you know, you get mad about a turnover. I looked at the bench, I'm like, my coach, just get back. Sam was just like, it's like, I'm like, oh, like, that's not even a turnover, really. Like, I probably shouldn't even count for real. Like, there's nothing I can do about that. I mean, it was a good pass, kind of. But, I mean, he, just always being such a threat with his touch and his length, and like, if he gets that angle on you, he's actually gonna stretch all the way to the basket. Like, it's not even like you really don't have a chance if he gets that angle. So
wait, he didn't catch you, did he?
Was there anything even close to him?
Did he catch you?
Did he catch me?
You know what I'm talking about, bro.
Did he catch you?
Hold on, let me make sure, bro, you didn't get caught.
Oh, Devin's trying to act like he dunked on you. Oh, did Wemby dunk on you?
He dunked. I remember him dunking one time, and I just kind of looked at it.
Okay, you didn't get caught. You didn't get caught. You're good. I was worried you got caught.
Nah, it's okay. I've gotten caught before. I get it.
Who was the best team you played against this year?
Denver.
By a long shot, or just like by like is there like is a there's like a close second place?
The Magic beat us pretty good.
Magic did kick our butts.
I can't say other words.
I'm gonna be
interested in them because they're playing the Cavs in the playoffs
on Tubi.
And I will say, it is
the game of Tubi series.
Like, their shooting numbers are abysmal.
Yeah,
and it's like, all right, what about when are they gonna be able to make shots when they're game planned against?
Yeah,
because they make. Their whole offense is in the paint.
Yeah,
and that's actually what Cleveland is good at. Yeah, stopping you. Did you see what Cleveland did yesterday?
What, they took everybody out in the fourth quarter,
bro? They didn't want Philly, so they looked up at the scoreboard. Max Strus and them were still in with 6 minutes left to go. They were up by six.
They said,
"Mess my boy JB, your boy JB." Our boy JB, and then he had to go and explain it away after the game. Ooh. Bro, he put in four centers and Imani Bates.
Really? Hey,
and they got outscored 18-2 the rest of the game.
Dang, bro. You should be.
All right, we'll see you. We'll see you versus Orlando.
Hey, you can get fined for that, can't you?
No.
NBA PA president. Come on, bro.
Cannot get fined for that.
Imani Bates. Hey.
Vice president.
Hey. My bad. Imani Bates
and four centers.
Yeah. Hey, he said Imani. Remember I told you a couple years ago, he said Imani's one of them ones. Like, he can be. Remember you say like an open gym?
Yeah.
Like, he was like cooking like pros. Like,
Imani was cooking at
14. Your dad is the first guy that ever told me about Imani Bates, actually.
Oh, yeah. I mean, bro, Imani is that guy. Yeah, I've seen Imani make like 85 threes in a row in a shooting drill. I'm like,
what makes Denver so good though? Like, I want to know because you said Denver's
they're all
the best
on the same page, bro. They're reading each other's mind. They played with each other 100 times. They're very, very talented. Jokic isn't missing from anywhere, and then Jamal Murray is nice. You have to take something away, and they know that. So as soon as you decide to take something away, they're going to just make the other read. It's not like anyone's going to force it and try to be great. Lobbed Aaron Gordon. Kick out three. Michael Porter doesn't care who's in front of him.
Yeah. KCP playing his role.
The bench is athletic and plays defense.
Yeah. Like, I didn't realize how athletic he was, bro. He took off against us. I said, hold on, bro.
Yeah, don't jump, bro.
Hey, you're out of – right. Obviously, you're not going to be you get to watch all these playoffs, right, mm-hmm. like everybody else does. And you see the way that these teams, like last year, you guys were a super young team that then had to go face the Lakers like right off the bat. That might be the same fate of the Oklahoma City Thunder. We don't know. We don't know who's going to be playing who. Or they might have to face the Warriors if the Warriors can get there, whatever it was. After going through it, and they're the youngest team to ever get the one seed by 2 years.
Wow.
They're the number, right? But no, as a young team going into the playoffs, after you take a step back, what do you wish you knew about going into the playoffs as a young team? Because you guys got to do it a couple years ago, right? You played that Utah series, and then obviously you gained steam from that, and then you played the two series the next year, and then you played last year against the Lakers. Like, what is it? What do you have to go through as a young team when everybody says, you know, everybody's got to take their playoff scars? What do you learn from that, from going through it the first time?
Details really do matter. You know, can't lack at any point. A play will change the series. It's really not about how much better a team is. It's just about how well you play in this little two-week span and how well you match up with a team. So really, no one should take it personal if you're not out there. It's just about beating this team. It's not about the big picture. There is no big picture until you win the round. You can't play the playoffs. You got to play the team. So,
is it hard not to be overtaken by the bright lights of the playoffs when you're young?
It's lit.
Young teams don't win. They just don't.
It's loud.
Right?
It's lit. It's whatever. I mean,
every possession matters.
I feel what you mean. Young team, it's just a little bit different. Like, I haven't figured all that out yet.
Everybody's always brash, right? You're seeing it now, right? With the brashness. It's like, all right, we'll play them, right? Like, I mean, you see it coming through. I even saw a press conference with Edwards yesterday. He's getting a little spicy, right? Yeah. It's like, everybody's got to go through because they're going to play Phoenix. Phoenix got all those vets. And Phoenix got those guys that have been through it, right?
They got Kevin Durant. We got Jaden McDaniels.
Right.
Yeah, yes. He said that.
He said that. He said it. It's like,
he can guard.
Huh?
He can guard.
He can't guard.
Jaden McDaniels.
It's Kevin Durant, Jared.
What do you mean?
No, I mean, we know, but I mean, like, when somebody's, we know the way that gets used as fuel. Same way Dylan's stuff got used as fuel, right? Anthony Edwards saying, oh, they got Kevin Durant, we got Jaden McDaniels.
That's crazy.
The second Kevin Durant has 38 points, it's going to come back up. Oh, we got Jaden McDaniels. Ooh. Yeah. That's the way it goes, right?
Hashtag internet.
Yeah.
That's the world. Well, I want to ask you about the draft tonight. Are you going to be watching the draft tonight? You know what draft's tonight. Caitlin Clark's getting drafted.
Am I going to watch?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, I mean.
You excited about her?
Going, he's trying to give you the answers, Jay.
It's great.
He looked at me like
media train. Hashtag media train.
I'm just trying. No,
it's lit, bro.
That's what I need.
My mom's at the draft.
That's what I need.
Is it A, B, C, or D?
Yeah.
I'm a college tutor.
I just want to ask you about the draft because I know you tapped into that world. So
no, it's lit. I mean, I'm happy for the year everybody had in college this year. It was crazy.
Yeah.
Caitlin, she's insane. And, I'm happy for everybody that's going to go tonight. Angel,
Yeah, it's terrible answer. Kelsey, tell him how terrible the answer was.
You think it was a terrible
answer? It's a terrible answer.
What's a good answer, though?
I don't know. You just, you gotta be, I want you to be real, bro.
You're just asking me, you just asked me how I feel about the draft and if I'm gonna watch and how I feel about it.
Yes,
it's a terrible question.
I always ask you how you feel about
NBA player. How do I feel about the WNBA draft? My mom is, you know what my mom is?
Yes, I know
who you're gonna say what my mom is.
I'll ask you how you feel about a lot.
Like, what are we talking about?
Get it, Jared!
Hey, he knows. I always ask him how he feels about everything, so he should be used to it by now.
Get him, Jared!
Chat!
Hey, what was your mindset in the fourth quarter?
I asked him how he feels about everything.
Did you want to win?
Did you want to win or lose the game?
What's going on? Like when you saw the score, like, did you think, ooh, I'm down or ooh, I'm up?
Look, bro.
Probably depends on if I was down.
Or is up. That when you felt like you really had to lock in?
What's your favorite questions?
Yeah, I want to know.
I like talk about.
Talk about is crazy.
I like talk
not
about.
Not even a question, but hey, you're just
talking
about
I like it when they just say everything that they want you to say and then ask it. They'll be like, yeah, like, you know, Jaren, you went out there. It was a tough first quarter. Ended up going like 4 for 15 or something like that. You know, how tough was it? be like tough.
Sure. 4 for 15.
How pretty tough.
Be like,
pretty tough.
Pretty tough. I mean, you know, when you say it like that, I mean, it's just, you know, I'll look at them and be like, well said.
Well said. It was very tough.
And then they look at me like they hate me because they can't give well said to their boss.
To their public campaign, well said is a quote.
Yeah.
No, you can't do
it's
that.
Funny. Like I always find out like who all the reporters work for, so I can just know that. It's funny. Like I probably know who are the more sticklers just because of that, and it's so funny. Like when reporters change companies, but they still are there.
Mm-hmm.
They kind of ask a little bit different questions than they did in the past, and then they look kind of sad about it.
Wait, you do that much research?
I mean, it's not.
You
that
tapped hard. In like that?
But he knows about.
I mean,
speed
just
balls.
With the ones I like, I see.
You see the most.
So
yeah.
Like, yeah. Okay. You know,
the ones you have to answer questions from on a regular basis, right?
Drew, you know?
Yeah.
Drew.
Shout out boy Drew Hill, man.
Drew wrote an amazing piece on me, by the way.
He did.
Three-part series.
A little deep dive. Really,
really good. Drew just got married over the weekend, too.
He did? Yeah, congrats.
Shout out Drew Hill. He got married over the weekend. Yeah,
that's dope.
Congrats to Drew Hill.
He did a deep dive on you for sure.
Yeah, he did. He did do a deep dive.
How about players around the league and like guys that have blown up? I want to ask you about one specifically, and that's Brunson. When Brunson signed his contract, I remember Ja and Dez both going completely out of their way to talk about how great, you know, he is, and like, people don't get it, right?
I saw it in USA. I mean, the dude just works harder than anyone. Like, he just works hard. And, yeah, I mean, he's so skilled. Like, he just has all these counters because he knows he's not, like, as athletic. Like, he's always talking about how, like, he can't dunk over somebody and stuff like that. And those type of players, like, they know to stick, they gotta have a little bit extra sizzle. I don't fucking know, some work, but like they gotta have something. They gotta have a bag for real at all times. You have to have a bag. There is no play where you can just get bailed out by something that you're God gifted at. So
they're the 2 seed in the Eastern Conference.
Yeah. No,
it's unbelievable what he's done this year.
And Julius Randle's hurt.
And he's had like a Curry-esque season.
Yeah,
like
cooking.
You go look at his numbers, it's freakish what he has done. And it has been on his lap. And yet you guys, you guys had always struggled with Dallas, but like all you guys were very effusive in praise. And I'll never forget, he signed that contract and like immediately there were a bunch of Grizzlies being like, no. People don't understand how good this guy is.
They don't get it. This is definitely what he is. This is definitely what he deserves, for sure. I mean,
well, now it's the bargain of all bargains.
Yeah.
His contract.
Who is a dude like that, though, that we don't talk about that you think, like, y'all in, like, y'all's world think of somebody's nice?
Yeah, who has a better reputation amongst players than maybe media or the amount of attention that they get.
Maybe DeJounte Murray.
Really?
He got smoked with DeJounte.
Who?
Oh, yeah.
U.S. Smokers.
Yeah, he tweeted at him one time.
All right, well,
maybe,
DeJounte Murray.
We're on your show.
What did he say? What did he say to you?
What did he say to him, bro?
I don't know. You said something like the
dumbasses just be talking.
The trade rumors. That's what you said.
Yeah, no, he did. He said that about me. Because one of my semi bowl predictions was that he was gonna get traded. And he got mad at me.
Which they tried to.
They did try to trade his ass.
Kyrie.
Yeah, he's a dumb.
Oh,
yeah.
Everybody loves Kyrie. Yeah. All the players love Kyrie.
We know Kyrie's nice, bro. Give us one that's like off the. That's like one that people don't really talk about that much. Like, we know the Kais, the KDs, the SGAs. Like, one of y'all watching, like, you know what, bro? He is nice.
A big guy that you've gone up against. You just do it with somebody that you thought maybe you had a perception of them, but they gave you more problems than.
Hardenstein.
That's a good one.
I love that one, Jaren.
Man set some Steven Adams screens.
I mean, he's just strong. He's just got better, like, since he was on the Clippers. I just remember, like, he's just more skilled. He knows how to play the glass. He knows how to use his size better. I just felt like he's better. He's a great screener. He gets out quick in the role. He knows how to play the game.
So when you played against him, you ended up after the game being like, wow, that dude is better than I thought he was.
I don't even think I played.
I think I was just really in awe. He had about 50 rebounds against us in the game here.
Yeah.
You played 66 this year, so I will give you that. Like, you played more games since this year than you ever played, so give me 66.
Wait, this is the most games he's ever played? No.
Let me double check that. I think that's.
No, I played. Well,
I thought you had a 70.
You played 78, 21, 22.
Yeah.
But 66 is.
78?
You played 78 games, 21, 22.
What a year.
What a year.
What a year.
What year was that? Was that the.
I don't know, bro.
How much has. Well, can you talk about things that with the Players Association would deal with or no?
I mean, if you say anything about anything and I don't want to talk about it, I'm just not going to talk about it. And then I'm going to talk to the chat.
65 game rule.
65 game rule?
Yeah.
How many games did I play?
You played 66 games, Jaren Jackson Jr.
Sounds like a good rule then, huh?
You think it's a good rule?
Chat. You know what I'm talking about?
Don't get aggregated, bro. Don't get aggregated because you are.
Yeah, no. I mean, like, if I wasn't on the board, I would probably answer you.
You think so?
Yeah, I think I'd answer you because I'd be like, you know, I'd be one of the players who just want to voice their opinion. But no, like, I got to report to Iggy and CJ and
you know,
Grant
Let me ask you this. Let me ask you this: do you think that because I thought about this last night? And I know that we just did that in-season tournament for the first time this past year, right? Mm. And it did work out in a way, I think, to bolster that because I was there in Vegas when the Pelicans played against the Lakers and saw that, and now those teams are going to be playing in the play-in against each other. I was there when the Bucks played the Pacers and Haliburton became like a star to the NBA, and now the Bucks are going to be playing the Pacers. Do you think that the in-season tournament, do you think players will look at that maybe more favorably than they did in year one, being more attuned to it, caring about it, and everything else? Because now we look back, and there actually was some really good stuff that came out of it, no matter what anybody thought about it at the time.
Yeah, I think people will care. I mean, there's money on the line. I don't think people looked at it that negatively.
I just think they didn't know. There was a lot of players in the league that were like, hey, I don't even know what it is.
They just didn't know about the seeding and that kind of thing. I don't know if that will ever really change, though. It's not easy to know because you're also thinking about your conference, your division. Just go out there and win games.
Right.
Things will fall into place. The games are on every Friday or something. It was like a whole thing. Like, I don't think anybody played any less or more hard in any of the games. I don't think that's...
The Lakers did.
What? In the games that for the end season? Yeah. I mean, I guess
so. I mean, LeBron decided he was going to defend. He defended Zion every possession. He was like, dude, you're not doing anything ever.
He was like,
Zion was like, this sucks.
But that's when it was in Vegas.
Yes.
But by the time that happens, then you know. Oh, then you probably should
be locked in.
Yes.
But like,
Just the regular ones where you go from like play in to regular season, play in the regular season.
You couldn't tell the difference.
Because we did the Portland one. We played Portland regular season, then the next game was a play in.
Yeah.
There wasn't like a, hey guys, this is a play in tournament game.
Win a game. Yeah. That was it. I mean, at that point, we hadn't won.
Yeah,
so, we had one.
We won that game. It was a big deal. I was not trying to come back. You know our crowd. They ain't trying to come back 07.
I actually was pretty impressed with you guys, this crowd this year. They were there. They showed up they like stuck with this team even though it was a down year.
Yeah.
Right?
I mean,
like
that's love.
We did not go to the arena and it felt like super depressing.
You're not trying to pull up 07.
No.
Anywhere. Like,
no.
We're on the road. You're coming back home. You want to come back with a little win. Look.
Yeah,
it's like we come back from war. Like,
that's right.
You bring home something, a win.
That's right.
Isn't that happen? Like the carriages roll in from war. You see everybody that made it.
Did you clap? Look at that man. Listen to social studies class.
Well, I watch a lot of stuff. But
What are you watching now?
How is everything changed in terms of what you do off the court? You still watching a ton of shows?
I don't have time for that, for real. I kind of rewatch stuff.
Yes, do have time. You guys have so much downtime. What are you talking about?
Hey. No, I don't.
All right, take us through a Jaren Jackson Jr. day.
Yeah, the president.
Sound like Devin, because Devin had an intern follow him like 2 weeks ago, and the intern basically was like, what does he do?
Was that when you had the little intern by the speaker?
Yeah.
Bro, that was funny.
Hey.
Bro.
Yeah. Little interns walking around.
Hey, Devin came back to us and he's like, you know, I realize I don't do all that much. But I got somebody watching
that was
my day.
That was a slow week. That was a slow week. Don't say that on the microphone because the people listening. It's review month. I don't need that. I don't need them to be out there.
All right. My bad.
Yeah. Hey, Jan, say something good about what we do on social. It's review month.
Say it.
You're very, you know, when you're off the leash, you know, you do great work.
There we go.
Hey. All right. What do you?
And it goes viral. My grandma likes it. It's funny.
Shout out grandma, man.
Yeah.
Take us through a day.
Wake up, ride the bike.
What kind of bike? Like an Aerodyne or whatever?
It's like a Peloton kind of bike.
Do you do the classes?
It's not a Peloton. I just forget the name. I have the app for it. It's called...
You have a personal bike, bro? It's a bike in my house.
It's a Wahoo app.
Wahoo?
Yeah, I mean, they don't pay me, so...
Where do you get a bike for a 7-footer?
The organization referred me like to a nice bike that fits me. And I have the same bike here, so like it mirrors it. So I have a bike at my house. That's where I watch TV. Like,
is the seat just like super high?
Yeah, if I wanted to.
So it's like a regular bike, but then you have to make the site.
It's a mounted bicycle with a wheel. It's just in the ground.
Gotcha.
And so I ride
that. But it's not classes.
No. Ride that for like 30 minutes.
That's the first thing you did.
Wake up, brush my teeth, and then do that.
You go get on the bike.
Take calls or like text, figure out my day.
Hold on, time out. How long are we on the bike?
30.
Which is... How many are you doing miles, or are you just doing 30 minutes?
At like 150 RPM, 150, 160.
So how many miles is that in like 3 minutes or 30 minutes, I mean?
I burn like around 300 calories.
300 calories.
30 minutes.
Gotcha.
So that's what I know. And then
are you sweating?
Yeah.
Yo, okay.
Do that, shower, figure out your day a little bit on the phone, maybe call somebody, maybe watch. I got a TV right there. Watch something. I'd be rewatching stuff just like, because I don't really feel like paying attention to it that hard because I'm thinking about other stuff. So I just put on like Ozark, watch Ozark.
Is that your favorite show?
It's a good show. I mean,
Rick and Morty, you got a lot of stuff going on.
Rick and Morty's cool. I mean, you know, it's just something to have on. Like, there's no time to really sit down and be like, I'm watching a show right now and I'm paying attention to it. Like, that only happens if like,
you were like,
if like Love is Blind is on or something.
I remember. I remember when
the homies got to watch. It's time to watch Love is, like, my homies watching Love is Blind at the crib right now, and I've already finished it. And we and some of my other homies like I've already watched it, so we know where he's at. We're like, bro, we don't even want to spoil it, but we want to see your reaction to it when it happens. So hit us when, you know, that comes up. But whatever. So I do.
Do you watch that and wish you could be on a show like that?
No.
Or
Love
no.
Is Blind?
No. You don't. You don't watch reality shows and think of what it would be like if you were on there. He watches all of
them.
He wants to be on these shows.
Yeah. Like the Circle, you know the Circle, bro?
Oh, you'll do great on that.
I would be great on the Circle, right?
Yeah.
I would win that.
You'd be good on that.
If I ever disappear,
you don't want to be on the Love shows, though.
No, I want to be on the Love show. But if I ever disappear, that's where I went.
Yeah, I don't want to be on that. I mean, we would shoot when me and Devin had our little show. We was talking about that stuff all the time. Our it was a little bit different than this. People, a little bit.
We had some.
So whatever.
You gotta bring that back, by the way. We need that back.
Yeah, we'll figure that out.
Get it together.
So Ozark or whatever you're gonna watch in the morning, and then what?
Yeah, eat some food. Go to the gym. Lift, practice. You know, work out. Leave the gym, and then it's probably like, okay, you probably got a meeting. Like I got. Different teams of people I got meetings with. So like social people, creative director, my mother, MBPA. I don't really got time to like record like that either. Like I record all the time, but do I record as much as I used to? Nah, not really. Like I'm probably gonna be done soon. Like my last album's probably be September. I'm gonna drop my last album. I'm done.
You're done rapping.
You're retiring.
I'm retiring.
Like is this like Jay-Z? I'll believe it
when I see it, bro.
What about
Jay-Z? Like when I say I'm done, I'm done.
What about the clothes stuff? Huh?
The clothes?
Yeah,
We got stuff coming. About to start a new brand this summer.
You are?
Yeah.
Not the same thing that you had.
The monocule?
No. I got a couple things. Can't really get into that yet. But I'm working on, that's what the meetings are. So I'm working on, I got to travel and get that done.
Can you make clothes for us regular size people?
Hey, the drip this year, do you feel like you toned it down? I felt less adventurous.
I found a pocket. Like I found different pockets that I'm good in this year, and it was a little less experimental. We still had moments though. Don't play.
We had some great moments. Hey, by the way, since we're here, League Fits, since we standing here, League Fits, make sure y'all get it right this year, bro.
Ian, my bad.
Get it right this year,
but
bro.
You were like
he snubbed him 2 years in a row.
No, you were covering. You were carrying briefcases. You had furs. You had like I felt like
I didn't have furs this year.
I don't remember.
You probably. You wore like a.
I just had good stuff this year. It was just quality stuff. Is this the camera?
No, camera's up there. Look, hold it up. That was in there.
What
there
is that?
That's one.
That's League Fits.
He's going through his fits.
That's tough. Hold on.
He's going through his fit photos now.
Oh my god.
Here's one. I can't really see it that well, but yeah, there's another one. That was fire.
I wish we would have known you were coming up here. I would have put together a greatest hits of this year's.
You had good ones.
I'm gonna put it together.
Is there anything that you wore?
That one was hot. Yeah, that one was.
Oh, the Technicolor Dream Coat, the furry Dream Coat.
I had a pink coat that touched the floor in Brooklyn.
You did have a pink coat that touched the floor.
He's like Cameron, bro.
You have not Cameron. Yeah. I didn't say you'd fallen off. I just said
I know you didn't say that. Because then you'd just be lying.
I'm going to stand
on the clothes. Like,
you see
hard,
these.
Like,
you see these.
No, you stand on no, business.
You Chat, see, come on.
You see some of these other guys, and they're like, no, I'll wear the most ridiculous thing ever. Right?
Like, what's the name does that, I feel like?
I thought you went through a mode where Jaylen you were willing Williams. To wear literally anything.
He just does anything.
Who?
Jaylen Williams just does anything.
Love is not blind, by the way.
Oh, you don't believe that?
You don't get deep, bro.
It's not deep. It's just not blind. That's not deep. It's just not blind. It's actually the opposite of deep.
It's very surface level?
No. Well, that's a surface level comment, but yeah. It's not blind.
It's not blind.
All right, let me ask you about the playoffs.
Basketball.
Yep.
Oh, back to sports.
Which of the series are you most interested in? We don't have Boston or New York's opponents yet. We don't have OKC's in Denver
right now, bro.
All right, Minnesota, Phoenix. They're playing each other.
Okay, tough.
And then we got Clippers, Dallas. Which do you think you will watch more of?
Clippers, Dallas.
Why?
Because it's just. I mean, somebody got to lose, and it's gonna be heartbreaking.
Dallas got unbelievable this last night.
I mean, it's just heartbreaking whoever loses that series because you know both of those teams are really trying to turn that corner. So someone's got to lose.
Look at you. Put them on TNT.
Bucks, Indiana, Cleveland, Orlando.
Indiana Bucks for sure. And what's the other one?
Cleveland, Orlando.
Great. There's no way you
I mean, they're all really, really nice. Cleveland, Orlando for sure. Yeah. I mean, Paolo, my dog, I mean, he's been having a great
year. Friend?
Yeah, I mean, FIBA, he was nice, but he's against us.
Yeah, I know. But you like, you know what? It's funny you bring up the FIBA thing, right? Brunson stood out to you, right? Because you saw his work ethic, and then obviously you got to be around Paolo. What do you think the biggest takeaway was from being around that group of guys for you?
I think the takeaway was that chemistry is very important, because you can have a lot of talent and it's still, you gotta be in sync. I mean, those guys played with each other since they were 10 and we haven't played with each other at all. Right. So we had a couple weeks to get ready, and team chemistry is everything. I think we were really close as a group, which is why I think everybody would have rather we won it, because I don't think it's easier to like come back together when you win it. But I think we're just like, damn, like we just remember that last little couple games. And But I don't know, man. That was very fun. Great experience. Great group of guys. That was the best part about it, was the people playing. Like,
do you think it impacted your season that you had this year?
In what way? Positively?
Yeah, positively.
Because, you know, you
maybe a little bit.
Do you think being around all of those guys helped you?
Yeah, for sure. And I think the training room and different training staff, people too, learning about my body differently, how they take care of their body, how they view the gear.
Give me an example.
Needling.
What's that?
That sounds like
needling. You get needles put in you. Just in different areas. I've seen Cam Johnson do that a lot.
How often do you do it?
I mean, you can do it as often as you want. Really every other day type of thing.
Does it hurt?
It's a little uncomfortable, for sure. Yeah. I don't really do it too much. I actually think I learned I didn't really like it, but I tried it.
That sounds crazy.
Yeah, it's like it resets your body. And then I, you know, just.
What about things that guys do
BFR,
to like, yeah, prepare their
BFR,
bodies?
I did that. I just had a routine with that, doing BFR, passively laying with these cuffs on that cut off the blood circulation of my legs so they can heal and stuff like that.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I mean, you know, icing and just like routines. Like, I'm in such a routine with my body. It's ridiculous. Like, you know what I mean?
And do you think you gleaned a lot of that from being at that and seeing the way those guys go about and getting their bodies ready for?
Yeah, that helps.
Who has the most, like, I don't want to say outlandish, because that can be used as a bad word, like, yeah. But who has the most extensive
on that team?
Yeah, like of the guys you were around, where you're like, wow, I had no idea this guy puts this much into just staying healthy.
Cam Johnson.
Really?
He was just doing so much needling and so much stretching and stuff. He's always in the training room.
Really?
Yeah, he was working on stuff. Mikael. I mean, that was some really Brooklyn.
Mikael
thing.
Bridges. Brooklyn. And Mikael Bridges, did you see this? Played. He's played. What is it? He like
I think he played.
He has never missed a game or some crap. Mm-hmm. It's something crazy. Go look at how many games he has played. It's something wild. It was consecutive games played or whatever. Mikael Bridges.
He played all 82 this year, bro.
Hasn't missed a game for 6 consecutive seasons.
That's incredible.
He played all 82, yeah.
6 consecutive seasons. Yeah. And the guy has not missed a game.
That's crazy.
So what does Bridges do? How can we learn from him?
Jaren, you trying to get like that?
How does Bridges stay so healthy, Jaren?
Bro.
He told me one time,
I think he like rolled his ankle one time, and he was like, nah, I'm still going to play. Because, like, you know, it's in his head that he got a little streak.
Yeah.
But, I mean, he just, prayer and the Lord. Prayer.
You don't think he's a religious guy?
No, I'm just saying that's what you should do. I pray.
I wonder what he does, though. I wonder if there is something that Mikael Bridges does that other people could look at and take that has enabled him to play 6 consecutive years. Because, I mean, that's look, crazy. Some of it's luck, for
yeah,
sure, right?
Yeah, for sure.
You know, I mean, like, there's nothing you can do. When Marcus Smart breaks his finger, there's nothing he could have done to prevent that. When Ja came down on a guy's ankle a couple years ago, there's nothing you can do to prevent that, right? Mm-hmm. But there are certainly some things that are preventable.
Yes.
And somehow, this guy never has any of it happen.
Yeah, that's a lot of luck. Because, yeah, probably like a lot of luck. I feel like a lot of injuries are like luck. Like when you tore his meniscus in the bubble, I feel like it wasn't like a. Because you played through that whole thing. You were hurt.
I played through the game.
Yeah, you played through the game. Like, then you afterwards, you were like, oh.
Now, but you got a repair, right? That's why that took so long.
Yeah, I mean, you could,
because you can get it removed or repaired, but you were so young.
Mm-hmm. You just get it repaired. Take the long route. Yeah.
And you're seeing Embiid's trying to come back.
Yeah.
He had to bail out of two games this weekend.
It's tough. It's a tough decision you have to make. But we also weren't in a we were in the bubble in playoff position. But, I mean,
he's doing what Rob Williams did.
Oh, yeah.
Which is get back fast. But now you saw Rob, you know, tear his ACL this year.
That thing hit the ground hard. By the way, you led the NBA in isolation scoring this year. Do you know that?
Is that true?
Yeah.
Isolation scoring.
Isolation scoring. This guy right here led the NBA in that.
Nice.
Put some respect on it.
Who's the hardest to get a bucket on? ISO.
Bam.
Bam, what have I?
Bam. Mm-hmm.
I'm mad that I just have like an answer, like I didn't have to think or anything.
Yeah, you really just Bam, off the top. Sure. Like not, it's not Rudy Gobert.
Why? Why was Bam the hardest?
He's just so crazy. Just such good timing. He's amazing timing. Good length.
He's no good Diddy. No Diddy.
I'm not doing that. Just great timing. Timing will set you apart from a guy like me who is relying on timing a lot of times, trying to get you off timing and play with your mind a little bit.
Right.
He is the same way. He's a good offensive player too, so he probably knows when I'm going to shoot. That's kind of how I play defense as well. He's good. He's great.
Bam Adebayo. Yeah. How about that? The number one isolation scorer in the NBA. Yeah. There you go.
Got to it, man.
Says Bam Adebayo.
Yeah, hardest, I really am on here. By the way,
you
did. Not right.
Yeah, you just got. You got
paid on here.
You got.
When do I start getting paid for this?
When you do it consistently, bro.
Yeah,
do it consistently.
Seriously,
yeah, bro.
How much money? How much money?
Yeah, you got a max contract.
How much money you need, bro?
Why are you acting like money is just like once you get a lot, you just don't want more?
Okay, what do you want us to pay you in?
It's America.
Like, what the,
America. Hey, you want a cup?
What do you like that's not money that we can pay you?
Yeah, we can pay you in like goods.
Cookies. You need more cookies? Yeah,
cookies? You like cookies, bro?
What do you need? You want Devin to clean your house?
Nah, I ain't doing that shit. I ain't doing that. Wow, that's a wrap. Oh, sign me up for that.
Honestly, bro, I got some packing I got to do.
I'm not packing your stuff, bro.
What off-season plans? Legit. What are your off-season plans?
We are going to a cool place today.
Where? Oh, you're not gonna say?
No chance of saying it.
Yeah,
I'll
say it.
But it's not. It's nice. I'll tell you later.
Of the vacation places that you have been, you mentioned Turks earlier.
Mm-hmm.
What is the best vacation that you've been? What is the place that you would go if I asked you like, hey man, I got a chance to go on a trip. Where should I go?
Mm.
What do you think is the best?
I've been saving a lot of like my islands and like I haven't really been gone. I don't go to those.
Yeah.
I mean, I would go to Europe.
You ever been to Hot Paris. Springs?
I like going to Fashion Week. Fashion Week is like, it's Fashion Week. It's me.
Right.
So it's like, you know.
That's what you
I mean, where else? Like, but.
In terms of the relaxing places, relaxing, the beaches or wherever.
Me and Coach Taylor actually both love this place. It's right off of Italy. It's,
Is it Sicily?
No, it's that little lake.
Let me see. Lake in Italy. I got you.
It's right. It's off.
Which one of these is it? Look at it. Look at Google. Which one is it?
It's not even a lake. Oh, Lake Como. Lake Como.
Lake Como. Lake Como.
Lake Como is probably the most relaxing place in the world.
Why?
Bro, I mean,
it's known for its dramatic scenery.
Yeah, you're seeing mountains. You're seeing forests. You're seeing water. You're seeing.
It looks like something from a postcard, bro.
Yeah, bro. It's just
looks insane.
It's in Italy.
It does look like a postcard.
It looks like a postcard.
It's crazy.
What is this?
Yeah, like it's that type of level. Wow. Like it's like something like turn your phone off.
That was your favorite?
D&D?
Yeah. But I've saved a lot of my trips. Like I want to do it when I get older and I have a family. Like and go there for the first time with them so I can have a memory with them. I'm not trying to I mean I could go over there with my boys, but I mean like it's you know what time. I mean? It's like a little it's a little romantic. Yeah. I'm really not trying to look at the gang.
What's wrong with you, bro? You ever been to Hot Springs, Arkansas?
No.
Did we just go from Lake Como, Italy, to Hot Springs, Arkansas?
You got Rose over here? That's his favorite place to hang out.
That's not true, Jared.
Jared, it's
not true. Like,
Hot Springs. I feel like you go there and come back
First of all, I haven't been to Hot Springs since I was a kid, but the question was, if I'm telling you I'm buying you the vacation, you have 24 hours to go somewhere.
It's 48 hours, he said.
No, it was 24 hours. You're gone for one day. I said I wouldn't go. I'd rather just stay home. I don't want to pack bags, get on a plane, stay somewhere for 24 hours, then pack bags, get on a plane, fly back home, and then unpack bags. Like, I don't want to do that. I'd rather just stay home. But they said if I did, I said I'd just drive to Hot Springs. I'd go to freaking horse races and go gamble. It's
You're
3 hours
away.
You're
very like self-sufficient.
Yeah. Like, no, he's not.
He's not self-sufficient.
After how long he's had
to want to go out of town, man. Yeah, he's a homebody.
Yeah.
I respect it. I get it. I don't want to. Shoot. I love my house. I wasn't even about to go to Turks. I was about to stay here in my house all break. But
you think you're going to be here?
DC was like, no. And I was like, all right, bro, let's go.
You know? You think most of the team will be here quite a bit throughout the summer? Josh said he's going to be in Memphis.
We're always here for the most part.
Spending the offseason?
Except Fashion Week.
Outside of
be here.
Right.
Yeah.
You got Fashion Week this summer?
I have Fashion Week every year until I can't walk.
I'm giving you my job for like 5 seconds. What's our slogan for next year?
Our slogan?
Yeah. I know you're a big slogan guy.
Bet.
No. No, that's horrible.
Why not? Bet with a period?
No, like, bro.
Bet.
Not with
all that. That's pretty
bad. Because you have to like shake your head every time
that's
you do
bad.
It.
Okay. Maybe.
That's Jonte Porter.
Maybe.
Oh, God. That's crazy.
Chat, please. Chat, please.
Say I still something. Got my fastball, Jared.
Yo, that's crazy, Chat, bro.
I still got my fastball, Jared.
Chat, please.
That's crazy.
Say something. I'm not even looking at him.
Bro, you gotta.
Wow.
Hey. You can't use that.
Hey, I wonder they don't send nobody up here.
What do you mean?
They don't send nobody up in this
Come
show.
Come on, man.
Who's the last player that's been on this show? Me? Last year?
No.
Yes.
No. Last player? We all wait.
Like, not Tony.
Not retired?
Someone else.
Not current Grizzly.
Yeah.
Derek could come up here.
Derek?
No, what I'm saying, no, we haven't.
Yeah, he ain't coming up here.
Yes, he would. Marcus was on.
Marcus was on. How about
Zaire? Zaire was on.
How dare you?
Yeah. What do you mean on? The KJ podcast?
They've been on this show. Okay, yeah. Marcus has been on. Zaire's been on. Who else? We haven't had Luke.
KJ, what's your favorite?
Yeah, here.
What's your favorite episode?
Come here.
I want to know the other
podcast.
I want
to hear your questions. Come on.
Yeah.
She don't want
time to go back to work.
Hey, Jacob Gilley was on. Shout out Jay Gilley.
Oh, yeah.
The chat let me know that Jay Gilley was on.
I don't have headphones. I can hear.
Jitty was on.
Ask him the questions that we haven't asked so far.
What's the...
Why the camera's on me? Put the camera on her.
What's your favorite podcast?
This season?
Ever.
Of mine?
Trey Jemison. Mm-hmm.
Episode. Trey? What did he say? Was he all like, what did he do? I don't even watch that one.
Wow. Damn.
Well, no, not like that. I was going.
Did he just welcome me out of the show and then diss me?
I didn't have.
Okay.
What did he say?
Trey said.
He just gave
up. No, you know what? Trey had a really good story about how he was the man in high school and then he was not the man in college. And it taught him how to not be the man in the NBA. Like,
wow.
To, like, work harder. Mm. That was really nice.
That's touching.
My favorite was Gigi, though. Everyone saw that one.
Yeah, I saw that. That was it. I knew when I saw him going on there, I was like, oh, my God. He's about to go crazy.
He didn't, though.
Yeah, no, it was good.
He didn't act towards me the way he does in media, like, post games when he says wild stuff.
Oh, yeah. It was heartfelt.
It was very heartfelt.
I think Chris totally did this just so he could take a piss break.
Yeah, did he go to the bathroom?
Absolutely what he did.
Yeah, what is going on? What is happening?
Yeah, come on in. I was really just asking from there. And then he was like, come over here, sit down, and then...
Okay, so just talk to me about...
Yeah.
Talk about.
That's the work voice.
Yeah, do it. You got your reporter voice on.
My reporter voice is deep. Jaren.
no comment.
Jaren.
That's crazy.
10 points, 10 rebounds, that's 10 assists, 10 fouls, 10 turnovers.
10 turnovers.
What did you do to get locked in?
What did you see from your perspective?
This season, the whole season. What was your entire perspective the whole season?
You want to come back on now?
Yeah, Vernon, come on. Come back and sit down.
At all times.
I just...
We outed you for using her as an excuse to use the bathroom.
No.
No.
He's texting with his homeowners association right now.
Well, this has been fun. You didn't ask any good questions? All right, here's what we're doing.
Chat!
Here's what we're doing.
Shout out to the chat.
All right, no. This was a record-breaking year, Jaren Jackson Jr.
Oh, no.
Yep.
I know what's about to happen.
Yep.
Jaren, be ready.
I didn't. I was, yep. I was reading.
Lock, Jaren, lock in, bro.
I did say, like, you gotta be, something.
Jaren, lock in.
You've got to lock in. You got to lock in,
trip
Jaren.
Trip questions.
Huh? Trip questions? What are you talking
about? Really, no, really this is about to lock in. I need you to lock in for
you
this.
Need me to lock
I know what's about to happen right now.
What?
We're going to have to remember to name every player that played for this
season. No, you're not going to have to name every player that played this season.
Scotty, me, Trey, no. GG. I can do it.
You no. can do it?
Yeah.
No. You can name
all 32?
33, wasn't it?
0% chance you could name every player that played for the team this year.
I mean, I don't think.
There's no way.
I think I would get to a certain
okay,
number.
Okay, what's the number you would get to?
Probably 28. No.
This is what we're going to do.
He got it.
We are going to go through the team this year, okay? These are the guys that played for the team, and you have to say something about each player.
And give a thumbs up or a thumbs down.
No, don't do that.
And I'm going to I don't think everybody's on here. All right, Jaren Jackson Jr., Santi Aldama.
Thumbs
down. You can just give
we beat Spain
a word,
this year.
A word or a phrase about each guy.
Spanish.
All right. Roser hates
behind the back.
Just hates his
what?
Guts. He hates his guts. I mean,
don't
really.
Hate some.
You're no. mean.
I don't kidding. Hate the guy.
He just, mean, hate, he just hates watching him play.
But you know what's crazy?
I'm just not a fan of his game.
Like, shoot. I mean, we're different. I'm a big fan, so.
Hey, he has.
We're just kidding.
I got
he's blind. Had his TV for 11 years. He was on his TV. Right. It was fine.
Behind the back. I mean, shoot. Duke has a.
Man, he did try that behind the back in the Celtics game at the end.
We call him the Heme God. We call him the Heme God.
I feel it. I mean, right. you had 30 at that point. So, I mean, I'm going behind my head, too.
Right. John Conchar.
Jitty.
Bro, you are not good at this game.
No, this is good.
Jitty.
This is good.
Arms. Nice tats. No. Making that jersey look real good.
Y'all gave him the aux, too, a couple times before the games.
Yeah.
We got to talk about that.
Vince Williams Jr.
The Reaper. Yeah.
I like that.
All right, that's a good name. Reaper. Hey, there you go, Grizz Twitter. Y'all want a nickname
nah,
for him.
Please don't
Jaren
do
just
that,
gave you
one. Because I don't even know if you want that. That's just my nickname. If anyone wants to come along with me. All right, next.
Is he crazy?
Crazy? Vince? Yeah.
I feel like he's like smiling all the time, but we're like nervous.
Yeah, I mean,
we're nervous. I don't
crazy.
Know.
He's crazy. Everybody is, but he is for sure.
He is crazy.
You think I am?
No, I don't think you're crazy.
You're a little off, bro.
I think you're
low key.
I mean, you see more of me.
Yes, I'm saying. No, I'm a little, no,
I'm a little,
dude, but yeah.
I'm a little.
No, you're right. That's why you goofy. Fit in with us. It's goofy.
Yeah, silly. Yeah, no, you're,
silly.
He's a little off.
Zaire Williams.
Eight ball, alley-oop every game, reverse alley, leaks out, don't know how he gets down the court so fast, midi.
Gigi Jackson.
I mean, tadpole, infant.
Tadpole
is crazy.
Exciting player. Gonna be probably one of the best wings to ever play this game, honestly.
Oh, I
really
love that.
Really good singer and drummer.
He can sing?
He can sing, rap.
Like he can like actually harmonize.
The dude is a better musician. I mean, he...
Gigi's like all-around...
I won't let him drop music.
What do you think his ceiling is?
All-around good human.
Oh, his ceiling?
You think he could be an NBA like star?
Yes.
Star?
Oh,
all-star.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I think he could be the best at his position.
Just 6'10", can shoot, can dribble, can play defense.
I think he's that good.
And he can sing.
These two.
And he can
they
sing.
Did that.
Oh, don't try to put
when
it. Don't try to throw us under the bus. Don't do that.
If there was anyone on the hustle that could help us, they were like, nah.
I'm not even gonna see. I'm not gonna.
Well, let's not act like we just. Okay, then
Jaren just told me he could be the best in his position.
Okay, don't act like we just won 55 games. Okay, like let's not act like that. All right,
guy just had 44.
We lost 55.
By the way, do you know he broke the franchise record yesterday for field goal attempts?
That's he told me today.
That's disgusting. You never took more field goal attempts than that. Come on,
I took 30.
I know. 36.
Yeah, I mean,
that's a lot of shots, bro.
I get it.
Keep going.
I get it.
My time to shine. Desmond Bane.
Yeah, why'd you do the Brennan voice?
Will they be like, he's pulling it from Beale, from Germantown? Just there's no, I mean, he's all the range in the world. He's swole. He's probably the swolest shooter ever. And then, like, now he's driving and breaking off people.
He is the swolest shooter ever.
Yeah.
He's also got that drive to the right that he does the high off the glass.
Bro, I be trying to block. We've been playing against each other, especially when he was coming back. And like, I would hop into the games and play. I mean, that shot is real. Like, he's
you really got to go get that. Like, I was doing everything and still not times not getting it. And
so the short arm narratives, we got to kill those.
The what?
The short arm narratives.
They said he got narratives.
Yeah,
they said he got short arms.
They said he got short arms. Continue.
Kennard, new baby. Congrats.
You said you would trust him at the Masters. I saw.
Yes. Yo, it's crazy. I didn't even know he had like. I was like sitting on my couch. I'm like watching the Masters, and I'm just like, Luke, and I'm just like, you know what? I'm just gonna tweet it. Because I have to. Because, like, you know, it'd be fake of me not to. Like, I really do feel this. And then I looked up Luke Kennard golfing on Google, and I'm like, I knew it. Like, I knew I'd find something.
Because we tweeted photos out of it. Because we have people like me to go around and follow people everywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. That's what we're here for.
Do you think you said that about Luke because he's white?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Keep it a B, Trip.
Speaking of white, Jake LaRavia.
Another golfer.
That's crazy.
That's my man three, man. Holds his follow through longer than anybody.
The other night against the Lakers.
Bro, he walked
he
that
stood in front of the bench for like a minute.
Hey, shout out Jake,
man. I feel it.
He's trying to be the logo.
I feel it.
Y'all own his head about his TikTok, huh?
Oh, the.
Yeah.
No, I'm not on his head.
Dez,
I respect it.
Dez was on his head about the TikTok.
He was?
Roser.
I mean, to be fair, when I, you know, the mistrip thing we talk about, I don't know. When I'm on that, I'm going to be doing that.
You're going to be on the TikTok?
Yeah.
We're going to have to talk about that.
I'm a TikToker, bro.
Derrick Rose.
Old, wise. No, not old. Well, all right.
Older.
Wise.
There you go.
Spiritual. Extremely fast and athletic at any point he wants.
How is being around him valuable to you?
He has all the stories and the knowledge, and he has a whole
give me an example of something that a vet can impart. You know what I mean? Something that
life experience is huge, just like coming to him for, you know, lessons that he's learned in his life and just growing up and being a father and stuff like that. I go to him for so much stuff.
What's the most inspiring thing you think he said to you? I feel like every time he gets behind a microphone, he says something that resonates. Like today, he talked about everything coming full circle, about his son playing for Jai's AAU team and stuff like that.
Yeah, I mean, there's a reason for everything. He'll just say that. He'll say, that's why we're here. That's why we're working. There's a reason for everything.
Give me an example of something that you went to him for.
You know, just advice. Life advice.
Like relationship advice or like?
Life advice.
Life advice.
Yeah. We'll call it relationship advice. You know, gotta have a relationship.
Just things that are going on in life that you feel like he has been through and so he could tell you.
Yeah. It's good advice. We'll never share it.
I don't expect you to share the advice. I just wonder, like, how younger guys use having a guy like Derrick Ryan. I don't want to say use, but, like,
take advantage of his
wisdom. Yeah. Right.
Exploit.
And seeing the value in that, right? Having those kind of guys around and how valuable they can be. Just having him around.
It's huge. I mean, like, dude, he's a hero to us because he played at that time where we're looking up to people. And at the end of the time, he humanizes himself. He doesn't think he's anything. Like, he's just, and he works so hard. Like, he shows you by example. And if you have any questions, you can come to him. He's open. He's has all the time in the world for you, even though he has a family, which says a lot about his character. So,
I was very happy this morning when they made it clear he'll be here.
Yeah, D Rose the GOAT, man.
D Rose.
You know what I mean?
D Rose.
Trey Jemison. Speaking of hook shots,
gospel.
The king of the Baptist. Hook shots.
Hook shots, Baptist, strong, way too strong for his own good. Like, does not play fight well. We play fight, and I'll be like, bro, I can't play fight with you. I'm just kidding. Like, I'm just kidding.
He's the guy that doesn't know
he's
his own strength.
Strong. Like, he's
oh,
just,
that is so annoying.
I'll just play.
He doesn't realize how.
Can't play fight with straight, bro.
Is it like playing basketball against a football player?
Yeah, that's not.
You know what?
Yeah. This dude is really like.
He's so strong. He looks so strong. He's got muscles everywhere.
Yeah, bro.
And he's.
call him the bouncer.
Mm-hmm. The bouncer. Scottie Pippen Jr.
Well, you got a little like props in here. You see that?
Yeah.
Scottie Pippen, fast as lightning. Thinks he can Nash everything.
Thinks under
he can
the
Nash
basket.
Dribble everything. Not scared of anything. Great defender.
Reaching. He was better than I thought he was, honestly. Yeah. Like, I thought he is an NBA player.
He's nice.
He's for sure.
I'm about to link up with him in a couple days.
I saw him in the G League last year, his rookie season, and the player I saw in the G League and the player I saw this year, I mean, it's totally different.
Did you ever chop it up with Pops?
Development's not linear.
Chop it up with Pops?
Yeah, Scotty.
Oh, yeah, I saw him. I saw Pops out of the game. He was with my Pops.
Of course. OG stuff. Yeah. OG talk.
You know how that goes.
Marcus Smart. You have a perception of him before he ever becomes a member of this team, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then you meet him. How was that different or the same? What you thought Marcus Smart was going to be like as a teammate versus?
I thought he was a psycho before he got here.
You did?
Yeah.
Just from playing against him?
Yeah, he's a psycho.
He is?
Yeah. still a psycho.
In the best way, you know, he's a psycho. Training camp, we was fighting day one, like, you know? Like, in a good way. But,
yeah.
Like, you know, like.
He's that.
Like, we're boxing out, driven. And it's like, we're fouling, but, like, there's no calls in camp.
Right.
So it's like, you know, like ripping the jersey off. Like, it's just like. Our camp is like that, though. Like, you probably don't want to go to our camp if you're not really with it, because, you know. It's kind of like that. It's fun, though.
But he brings a level of intensity that
for sure.
He's
diving on the floor at random times. He's going to really try to, you know. You saw the pass he made in the Clipper game. Like, it's just, like, he's just an all-out. Like, it's like he's playing a different sport while he's playing.
Competes
basketball.
No matter.
Yeah.
Right.
Doesn't matter what's going on.
He just wants to win.
Yes. Like,
vocal. No,
doesn't matter what team he's on.
What was it like having him out?
Boston.
Yeah.
That was crazy. See him come back and everybody's chanting his name every couple minutes. Like, he's not even playing in the game.
Right.
And they love him. Like, it's just, it was crazy.
So he is about what you thought he was.
Yeah.
Lamar Stevens. Dude, I loved this guy.
Bro, I went home and looked. I mean, first day he got here, I mean, I remembered him because of Big Ten.
Oh,
he played at Penn State. Yeah.
I was like, oh, this is you. The highlights are disgusting.
Penn State?
Yeah.
Wait, you should have made me go look at Lamar Stevens.
I was calling X like, X, you remember this? Look at this. Frying you.
Oh.
Not really, but like, he got him, caught him up there. Like, you know, I hit Marcus right next to me in the locker room. I'm like, Mar. Nice. You know? But he knows he's nice. He's just super all around, athletic.
I want to keep him.
He's good.
Compete.
Really good.
Competes every another guy.
Yeah.
That like it just feels like he's always intense. We could be down by 20. Yeah. We could be up by 10. It doesn't matter. He's just like ball of fire every time he comes in.
How many
trying to make something happen.
I got this.
Tosun Adewamba.
Who?
Jordan Goodwin.
Tosun.
Yeah. That's what
jumping
I said.
As high as anything.
Okay. I just Jordan. Try to throw
speaking
him
of jumping high, Jordan Goodwin.
ISO buckets.
Jordan Goodwin gets every rebound.
Yeah, I know. Even more than me, low-key.
Crazy.
I'd be like, whoa,
why?
Buddy, slow down.
Why does Jordan Goodwin get more rebounds than you?
Because he's just, I don't know.
Chris,
if I knew, I'd get more rebounds.
Chris Jarquette.
No. Because that's the dark Twitter, bro.
That's Grizz Dark Web.
That's the Grizz Dark Web. They want you to get more rebounds.
They feel like they took over my soul.
They want me to get more rebounds.
They took
over. They want me to wear better clothes.
Yeah, they want you to do everything better, bro. They want you to like.
They want more albums.
Yeah, you know, you want me to tell you what they say? You want me to tell you right now?
I mean, I'm me. I feel like I know.
You're 7 foot. Why don't you get more rebounds?
I mean, I think I read that like under my album comments.
that's real assholery.
Video and they're mad about my rebounding. I think it was on my birthday too. I was like, damn. I thought I get
it's my birthday.
I thought I get nothing but love, and they're not over it. They don't care.
My parlay's not hitting.
They don't care, bro. They care about that, bro. I sat on the bench one time, and this dude had his phone out. He was like tapping his leg like this, you know, and he had his DraftKings right there on his lap. And then, like, something was happening in the game, and so he's like,
damn. He was mad you didn't hit the parlay?
It wasn't me. It was someone else in the game. And then I was like, dang it. Yeah, I was, like, sitting next to him.
Do you think that's ruining the game? I'm joking. Go ahead. Don't answer that question. Don't answer that question. Don't answer that question.
Xavier Simpson.
Hook shot. He wasn't here long.
Timmy Allen.
Oh, and he went to Michigan, so I hate him.
Timmy Allen.
No, Timmy Allen with the Texas, right?
No. He's talking about Xavier Simpson.
But I told him I hate him, though. And he told me he hated me, and it was love.
Timmy Allen.
Why are you looking at me?
I'm phoning a friend. That happens in some game shows.
All right. Jack White.
Come on. Memphis Hustle.
I already know that. I'm just saying. I'm trying
athletic. Good defender.
He's trying to think of something. He's athletic too. What's
good,
the next one?
Good Jack defender. White.
Defending. Duke. I hate Duke. Luke loves him. Hate Luke too. You know?
BC.
You know, I don't even know that guy.
I'm not even going to get to all these.
There's a lot of guys, bro.
You're starting to run out of steam.
Jack White.
BC. Yeah. Man goes BC, like,
that's
late.
That's an easy one.
You don't want to not be on my BC. Wrist.
You don't want to not be on my wrist.
Yeah, we got to get that next year.
And then John Morant. John Morant. Yeah. We didn't even get to all those G League guys, 10-day guys. Good. Huh?
He's kind of good, Ja.
We need him back, I think. I feel like we need him back.
No.
I feel like we might need John Morant back. How much of the playoffs are you going to watch?
Serious, like dead ass. Like how much do you think you're going to sit and watch? Like, I know you moving.
I'm more of like a start of the game, turn it off at around 6 minutes left in the second, come back at like 2 minutes left in the third kind of guy.
All right. Obviously, you guys can't win. So who would you root for? Who do you hope wins it if you guys can't?
Not sure. I hope the whole thing gets canceled.
I like. Hey, Roofer X.
Hey,
Roofer X.
Watch out, because there's gonna be a. Hey, there's gonna get aggregated.
Lockout.
Jaren Jackson Jr. hopes for a new pandemic.
Yeah.
Don't do that.
I hope we lock out and go to Disney. Honestly.
I mean, you already got aggregated for your media day interview.
Aggregated
for what?
For his USA basketball comments.
What did he say?
Aggregated mean.
Aggregated means like you say something on a podium or an interview.
Oh, and then it gets out there.
NBA Legion Hoops. Like puts you on like a quote graph, like puts like a photo of you.
And what did he say?
If I get that call, I'm in about USA basketball.
So you were trying. Trying to get the call.
That's what we hear.
No.
Yeah, no, I'm with you.
Get that call. Hey, root for your boy X, bro. Root for your boy X.
Yeah.
Root for X.
X what? Tillman?
Yes. For Boston.
Oh, Boston?
Yeah, root for him.
No, I don't care. Oh, yeah, well, cool. You know, from a personal perspective. That'd be dope.
Just X. Just root for X.
Oh, root for X.
Nobody else on the team.
Jaren Jackson Jr. will not root for Xavier Tillman.
Shut up, X.
Jaren Jackson Jr., quote, I don't care if X wins.
I don't care if anybody wins this because we're not in it, bro. I don't care. Hey, cancel the whole thing, bro.
Hey, real quick. The play-in is the next thing that's happening. I do want your basketball perspective on this. Do you remember, or how vividly do you remember? I know it can all run together. You guys were in this position, the do-or-die game against the Warriors. Mm-hmm. Do you remember this?
Mm-hmm.
You won at the Warriors in order to make the playoffs to play against Utah?
Yeah, and Ja hit a floater and started going like this.
Draymond threw it off the backboard, and it went to overtime. Yeah. Tillman... Grayson Allen hit a big shot too, right?
He got a board, stepped all the way out of bounds. They didn't call it, laid it in.
Yep.
I threw the pad in the air. My dad was over there going crazy.
Do you remember what going into that, like, did that play-in feel, because it's a one-game scenario, did that feel like even different than playoff games do?
There wasn't really that much pressure in that game.
Really?
I mean, we overachieved all year to everybody else's opinion, so... It was like, yo, this will be nice, but it wasn't even like a if not. It's like, you might as well go out and get this. This will be crazy. And it was probably the craziest we've ever celebrated anything to that point, to that time. We probably celebrated that more than winning the first round. Because, I mean, you we think won the first the round and had a game in 2 days at one.
Do you think you celebrated it more than Dylan's birthday when you guys went on like a 50-game losing streak?
How do you even know that?
Oh, Phoenix? I watched the team.
No, but how do you know?
They came up in that. Remember y'all did
how do you know what you know?
I did that slam thing,
it was
bro.
Dylan. He said after Dylan's. Okay, so you mean to tell me we lost after Dylan's birthday and we started losing?
Y'all were in Phoenix.
Yes, we were in Phoenix, and then we went to LA, and then we like had the worst. It was the worst West Coast road trip in maybe Grizzlies history. Yeah.
I remember that trip.
I bet you do.
The chat wants to know before you leave, bro.
Huh?
The chat wants to know before you leave.
They want to know.
Drake or Ross?
Oh.
Drake or Ross?
Ooh. Yes. No. Or Kendrick.
Ross
fired back.
I want you to be completely honest. Don't you lie, bro.
Devin's guy ran for the hills.
Okay, calm down.
He didn't want any of the smoke.
He just knew a beef was about to happen.
J-Fold.
He knew something was about to happen, so my guy got out of the way. You're picking Ken Carson.
I'm picking Ken Carson.
He's a maniac.
I'm picking Ken Carson. So if I'm picking Ken Carson, then
Ken Carson.
He's like on that Playboy Cardi, like screaming the microphone.
Yeah, you're not up on game, Chris.
What do you mean I'm in middle form?
Go stream overseas when you're done with this.
Hey, when is Playboy Cardi gonna actually drop his album? Because he's just putting all this stuff out on YouTube. I love 2024. Hood by Air is awesome too. Evil Jordan, good stuff.
Don't let him do that, bro. He poops on new dude, rap. All. That's all he does. Yeah.
He can't stand Cardi.
His TV at this house is 11 years old. Don't let him
do
that.
I like Cardi. I can't listen to like, I got about like 5 to 6 Cardi songs and then I'm like, okay, I got to turn
myself. So you don't pick Drake or Ross. Pick one. Because you know I know you heard the diss track.
Nah, I'm cool, bro.
Steering clear. Cool, hashtag media train.
You're a rapper. Why don't you just get involved in it?
Why don't I get involved?
Tell them all it ain't the big three. It's a big foe.
Yeah.
No, you can say Dez and Jaw are the real big three.
I'm not saying that. They don't rap.
They just ruined that.
Yeah, I know.
They just ruined that.
I like messing up.
You're messing up my
You trying to level a little flow going on. Oh
this
my
a
God! We said Ken Carson can't sell out Growlers. Hey, bro, you're funny, bro. Dang, that's crazy.
No. You see the last comment? You see the last comment, bro?
Yeah, because they want to nitpick.
I know. Yeah, we know what your real answer is. It's fine.
Wow, they're hating in here. I'm mad. Now I'm sad.
Don't be sad.
I'm more sad about this.
We told you you can't pay attention to the internet, Jaron.
Can't pay attention.
Can't pay attention to it. So you're gonna be going on a trip,
honestly,
and then you're gonna be around here. So you gotta just pop in with it throughout the summer.
I feel like there's not a lot of like on my feed. There's not a lot of like reviews on me. It's kind of like just real popular things, and internet and Twitter wise, it's been a pretty interesting last couple months.
It has.
So like,
Cat Williams started it all.
Yeah. So like in general, like you know.
But you can like your For You page. You can like get away from it easy though. Cause I feel like you don't really like go down timeline.
No, I mean timeline, bro. My timeline is all about what's going on with like Lil Yachty right now or something.
Yeah, see?
Lil Yachty, Kendrick.
What are you on the most? Instagram.
Baby. I'm on YouTube. I'm on YouTube Shorts.
YouTube Shorts.
I'm on YouTube Shorts a lot.
What's your algorithm like? What if I scrolled through it? Is there any basketball on
it's
there?
It's a lot
is it
of
all
Twitch
rap?
Stuff. It's a lot of Twitch. And a lot of like dating show YouTube stuff and a lot of
go ahead,
like,
do
crash
it.
Out stuff.
Do it. Do it.
One.
What's up, brother?
What's up, brother?
Yeah, there you go.
What's that, brother?
Tuesday.
Yeah, no, I'm not doing all that.
You
though.
Don't like the, you don't like those guys? Do you like Kai Cenat?
Yeah, Kai.
You like Kai?
Yeah, he's cool.
We're gonna mess around and see him on a stream sometimes.
He's cool. I like him, Duke, and you know,
Sketch.
AMP, yeah.
You don't like Sketch? Your brother? What about Jinx? You know him?
No.
He's one of them. So you watch a lot of the streamers.
Yeah. Neon just got locked up.
Neon.
Aiden. Scheme. Yeah. I know those guys. Rage. I've like hung out with them before.
You watch the streamers.
Yeah.
How often do you watch Jaron Jackson Jr. highlights? If we go to your crib right now, we go to your YouTube search history, will we see Jaron Jackson Jr. highlights?
Yeah.
How often do you watch them?
I watched But you're I didn't watch him for a while during the year. I just kind of wasn't really in the mood. I don't even know why. I just felt like whenever we have another game, it's just like. But I think I watched a lot when after the Bucks game. I watched the Bucks game.
Is the corner three your favorite play of the year?
By me?
I took a great photo of that, by the way.
Corner three, my favorite play of the year.
Say yes.
Yeah.
So because
that was hard.
Because then again, that makes my photo look even better.
Yeah. No,
that's an OD photo.
That photo. That's an OD.
Have you seen the photo?
The step back corner three is about, and it was a dagger.
Yeah, we won. It would have been, other than that, maybe it would have been like, one of the play, like Minnesota, when we were at Minnesota, we lost.
At Minnesota. That
you had a big game in Minnesota. You had a big game at Minnesota.
You destroy Rudy Gobert every time playing him.
It was just a lot of like me. But
can I ask you about this in all seriousness? Because you are a guy that like stretches the floor out all the way to the 3-point line and has to like attack drop coverage. We're about to see this with Phoenix. Here's a real basketball head question, right? What is key to dealing with that drop coverage when you are the big, right? Because we're going to see them space them out. That's what Phoenix is going to try to do. They've only got Nurk. He's the only big guy on their team. They don't have any other big guys, right?
Mm-hmm.
So they're going to try to go five wide, which is what teams used to do against Utah, right? They're going to try to pull Gobert away from the basket if they can, right? So when you are in that position, because you had this tremendous amount of success scoring against them, though their defense is great. So how? What are you trying to do attacking it?
Minnesota.
Yes.
I mean, it's tough with Nurk. I mean,
You
get Gobert away from the basket. You just got to get him away from the basket and make him play in space in terms of like offensively and defensively. Like, put, you know, make him make decisions for
you. They're just not going to play Nurkic and they're going to.
He's a decent decision maker like Rudy is. It's just like everyone else over there is just a more of a guard. Like, you know, so you pick your poison, really. You want Ant dribbling or you want Rudy dribbling from up there? You want Rudy dribbling, but you don't want Rudy on the block with no one around. So you just, you know, but it's hard. Minnesota's going to know that you're trying to do that and make adjustments and put him in positions where he's going to be successful. Probably put whoever he's guarding in the corner, drive, screen in, kind of like how we did with Wemby.
Do you think you cared more about being offensively aggressive because it was him on the other side?
Who? Rudy?
Yeah. Yes.
Probably because he was guarding me, yeah.
Yeah.
Last three games against Minnesota, 21-36-33.
I will say, though, like my game winner against San Antonio, that's all because of Coach. Like, the way Coach formatted it with me, like, we were really on the same page. I mean, he basically walked me through it, like, while I was on the court, too, while I was dribbling, and it was loud. I could hear him. Like, I threw it over, got it. It was like he had two plans for me. It was one if Wemby was guarding me and one if he wasn't. And Wemby didn't guard me. So I'm like, okay, plan B. You know, get it, burn clock. But I didn't know he pressured me all the way in the backcourt. So really just figure it out for a while. And then I went over to the wrong side, actually, of the court. And the coach was like, no, go over there. And I'm like trying to figure out if I have enough time to check at the clock and not get it ripped. So I'm looking at him. I'm like, okay, check the clock. See the clock, it's like, I know I have 9, so I'm counting in my head now. Now I don't have to look. 9, 8, bring it over here, 7, check again. Okay, I'm right, 6, 5. Now at 5, I can begin whatever I'm doing. Drive, whatever, put Wemby in the corner. As soon as I drive, Jake screens Wemby on the inside so he can't come help and block it over the top.
Hey,
so
man,
I know that's happening. So I don't have to rush it. I don't have to. All I got to do is worry about this guy. The help, the shift.
It's a great example of Taylor.
Yeah, the shift was a bluff. I saw that he knows he wants to take away my left. He bit on it. He thinks I might cross. I don't. The shift went in, stuck with me, went back out. So I'm not kicking to the shooter. I'm going in his body one more time. I hit him. I know I hit him. His chest caved. I know that if I shoot it, even if he jumps late, he'll just clap my hand. He's not going to hit me. So just shoot it, get it off, get hit. No Wemby. Game over.
So that's all scheme.
Taylor is the GOAT.
scheme god.
Yeah, Taylor set it up perfectly. It was crazy though.
That's crazy. That's a crazy breakdown because there's a lot of people that think that, like,
we'll have to make a video of it.
Yeah, because a lot of people think you just got at the top of the key and you just got to wherever you wanted to go and then you just scored.
What was going to happen if Wimby guarded you?
Well, I mean, we're not screening anybody. There's no help coming.
So it's now just...
It's now, like, probably not a floater. Probably a get all the way to the rim and get into his body and just try to maybe get a foul or get an and one. Or damn near come at him, get him going. If it's Wimby, he's probably not pressuring me in the backcourt. He's probably going to stay. So get it and get a full head of steam going, honestly, and stop and pull it for three.
Wow.
And try to game him like that. Or, like, stop it and, like, go and hezo the three. Like, fake the drive, fake the three, and then go back and then get into his body and then maybe pump fake and then get into his body again. Mm. So.
Wow.
That's he what thought I think it through. About.
That's a great, that's a whole breakdown.
I was thinking about a lot of stuff, like, in that moment. Your brain kind of goes on autopilot.
That's crazy.
Hey, but it has to feel good to get out there. They throw the ball to you, and you look up, and it's not the 7'5" guy.
Who was guarding on that? Was it? It was
Sohan, right?
Was it Sohan?
Yeah, it was Sohan.
Sohan.
Oh, he's too little. It's a baby. That's a baby down there.
When did you feel like you could just say whenever you want?
I think you know. It took, like, so you've been here for what, 6 years now?
Yeah.
I think it took 4 years. I think y'all's first, like, play-in run is when we started to really get cracking.
I'll say this. Hey, by the way, these little knobs right here are dirty.
What are you? Are you like the...
Bro, this shit...
That controls the volume in the
cat
headphone.
Here.
This is Homeowners Association, Jared.
we've
got to do something about this. Yeah.
It's really gross.
I'll sit over there.
We'll get somebody to come. You see my chair, bro? Oh,
man.
Come visit us this summer.
No, for real. Pull up.
Pull up.
We'll pay you. What kind of food you like?
It's fun over here. Yeah. Can't always come up here during the year because I'm focused, but you know.
Yeah. What kind of food you like, bro? We'll get you some.
Yeah.
Food.
We'll get you whatever food you want.
You just need to add another chair. I feel
where do you
bad
eat?
Taking
where do you
chairs.
Eat? Where do, we'll get you another chair. Where do you eat in Memphis?
Well, eat.
Where do you go if you're ordering in?
You want like the bougie answer or the real answer?
The real answer, bro. Don't do that bull crap.
Wing Guru wings, man.
Do you do DoorDash a lot?
A little bit.
Do you have a?
I have a chef.
You do?
Yeah.
Hold on. Okay.
He's a dog.
If you eat somewhere in Memphis besides Wing Guru.
Oh. Yeah. It's about to call the sombrero.
Oh, give it to him. Yep.
Oh.
Oh. Here we go.
Oh.
Oh, Jaren.
Are we viral?
Oh, Jaren. This is trouble. Here we go.
This is what happens when you lie on the show.
There
when
you
I
go.
Lie. Cap?
Yeah, bro. That's the cap. Yeah. Put the cap on. I know you got the deal with Wing Guru, and yes, the Trip J wings are great. Yes, I understand. But what are you actually eating, bro? Yeah.
What I eat. It's just a bunch of stuff health-wise to make your energy.
No, if
steak,
we're DoorDashing from your house.
If we're getting DoorDash straight up.
Yep.
No cap, I am getting Wing Guru, but I will say a different answer just so we can, you know.
Just somebody that's not paying you.
What's wrong with getting paid?
That's a great screen grab.
Maybe
Chick-fil-A.
I mean, we can look. Chick-fil-A is pretty good.
Chick-fil-A.
It'll say what I eat.
Don't lie.
Chick-fil-A. Last ordered or whatever, right? Yeah.
Chick-fil-A. You would do South Main sushi. Yeah, we can order Chick-fil-A up here.
Honestly, going to Chick-fil-A is you have to go.
What does it say? Your last orders.
Nah, these are different cities. These are different cities. Firehouse subs.
Okay.
Pretty good.
Okay. You're rocking Firehouse.
Recently viewed. Oh, order again. Let's go to this
one. Yeah.
Tommy's.
What's that?
Tommy's, this burger place, Firehouse Subs,
Outback. Tommy's?
Outback, Tropical Smoothie.
Tommy's Burger, California
style. I got
style.
Lenny's once. I don't know if it was me. Fleming's.
Oh, you love Fleming's.
Fleming's is hard.
Fleming's, okay.
I get that with my style.
What is Tommy's? Is that even a real place?
It's like Tommy's Burgers, California style. It's about on Park Avenue. Closed at 11 o'clock. Yeah. It's 4 stars on here, so yeah.
You gonna tell them how much
pictures
you paid
look good?
Yeah, so I paid you so much to be on the show today. Actually, you didn't. I didn't pay you.
You're like Cam Newton right now.
You kind of just like you saw us.
You should wear that on league fits next year.
Yo, I get how he feels because if you wear this, you can say whatever you want. If you got your eye, you see how my eyes are kind of.
Yeah, your eyes are kind of dark. Like it's like a
right now.
He does really look like Cam Newton.
So yeah, we gotta get you.
In all honesty, man. Like,
that's your cam voice. Go ahead. Get in your cam bag real quick. Go ahead. Yeah, like, go ahead.
That's why I didn't say anything. All I have to do is look at you and you stop talking.
No, all right, go ahead.
That's how much power I have right now with this hat. Yeah. All right, we're done.
I don't think I've ever seen you in a hat.
Oh, he wears
some hats on vacation.
He wears the ears.
You want some hat picks?
He'll wear the ears.
Oh, like winter hat.
Like, what's the little ears you be wearing, bro?
I'm talking like, when is the last time you wore a baseball hat?
Boop. There you go. That's a trip in a hat.
When is the last time you wore like a baseball cap, like what me and Devin have on?
Oh, I'm not doing that. I'm okay. That's y'all.
It's been done.
When is the last time you wore a hat?
I'm never wearing a fitted hat.
Boop.
Fitted hat?
By the way,
yeah, that's the next song title, by the way.
Fitted hat?
Fitted.
Oh.
Fitted is a... Look, it's literally called Fitted. I'm not kidding.
Oh, yeah.
It's actually good.
You guys send me that. I don't have that one.
Thanks for coming by, man.
Appreciate
you. I'm gonna leave.
I'll use some food. I'll use some food.
We're out of here.
It's time, guys. Everybody log off and go get some.
Great season by you.
Food.
Great season by you.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
23 a
Thank
game.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, chat. Thank you, fans.
23 a game. Yeah.
23 a game.
Hope y'all like my speech at the game. Yeah. Hope y'all like the vibes.
Number one ISO scorer in the league.
Yeah, bro.
You're doing basketball camps still this summer, aren't you?
For the youths.
I'm glad Jaren avoided this chat from 2020 to 2023.
Yeah, we had a guy named TMZ that hated every time he played basketball. So
yeah,
damn.
He hated you and LeBron James.
Yeah, really? Yeah, you and LeBron
and Mike Conley.
Yeah, Mike Conley. He said Mike Conley was overrated. Any chance?
That's funny, bro.
Yeah. Shout out TMZ, man.
Just gonna do it for the show.
I get it now, though. Like people are just there's very different people in the world. Like there's a lot of different people in the world. I get it.
There's a lot of different people.
I get it, bro.
The
world is really.
You're old now. You understand.
It's like food. Older. It's like food, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Everybody don't like everything. Every food, but some people are. Some people's taste. Some people's not.
The people be back tomorrow. Thanks, Jerry.
I might never leave the studio.
2024. Barracuda. November 14th, FedEx Forum. A journey through the hits and timeless classics. The iconic band returns with special guests. Jason Bonham's Led Zeppelin Evening. Tickets on sale now at heart-music.com. Heart with Jason Bonham's Led Zeppelin Evening. Produced by AEG Presents.
Today we have two very special guests on our program, introducing Lem and Lime.
Hello.
For Starry Lemon Lime Soda.
Thanks for having us.
What is Starry Lemon Lime Soda?
It's a crisp, clear burst of lemon lime flavor, and it's caffeine free.
Between us, one of you must be a little more important to Starry than the other. Who is it?
We're both important.
So we could just as easily be Starry Lime Lemon Soda.
No, that doesn't sound right.
Oh, I like it.
So you saying hip hop could be hop hip?
Works for me.
Starry Lemon Lime Soda. Starry hits different.
Students, get back to the grind and cheer on your Memphis Grizzlies at FedEx Forum. Don't miss out on our exclusive student ticket program presented by Big River Steel. Get affordable tickets for all the major showdowns, including matchups against the Lakers, Warriors, Nuggets, Celtics, and more. Sign up today to get alerts about this exclusive deal at grizzlies.com/students.
We know there's only one team you want to watch, and Bally Sports is the place to get your Grizzlies. Experience the comebacks, the buzzer beaters, the can't-miss Memphis-made moments live. Bally Sports keeps the grind going before and after the game, too, with Pete, Brevin, Fish, and Chris on Grizzlies Live. Watch Grizzlies basketball all season long with Bally Sports and streaming on the Bally Sports app. Bally Sports, home of the only team you want to watch.
Justin Timberlake. I'm bringing sexy back. The Forget Tomorrow World Tour. I can't stop the feeling. in Memphis. Justin Timberlake. FedEx Forum, Saturday, November 23rd. Get tickets now at LiveNation.com. The brand new single, Selfish, is available to stream and download now. For more, hit up JustinTimberlake.com. Let's face it, there's a lot of trash talk in basketball, but the great teams let their performance do the talking. Like Ford F-150 with Pro Power Onboard, a class-exclusive industry-first feature that turns your truck into a mobile generator and leaves the competition speechless. Ford F-150, official truck of the Grizzlies. Greatness starts here at your Mid-South Ford dealer. Classes full-size pickups under 8,500 pounds, GBWR.
Vince Williams is going to go to All-Star Weekend. Now, what a great thing for him.
Kudos to Vince Williams Jr. You know, he was an injury replacement on the Panini Rising Stars. He'll get a chance to be part of the All-Star Weekend Showcase.
Hey, Grizzlies fans, be sure to tune in to Grizzby, where the panel and I break down all things Grizzlies and take a look at the rest of the NBA as well. The show is live every Wednesday, 2 p.m. on YouTube at Grind City Media and the official Grind City Media app.
Don't worry, be fluffy world tour.
The minute you get into a brand new relationship, like magic, you know who really notices just how happy you are, guys? Other women, not your woman. Look how happy he is. Oh, I bet I can change that.
Friday, May 10th, FedEx Forum. Get your tickets now at fluffyguy.com. Don't miss a Memphis. Don't worry, be fluffy world tour.
Maxwell in concert. The Serenade Tour. October 16th at FedEx Forum. Maxwell. With special guest Jasmine Sullivan. And October London. Tickets on sale now at LiveNation.com. Don't miss Maxwell Live.
LifeCare Ambulance is proud to be an official partner of the Memphis Grizzlies and FedEx Forum. At LifeCare, they wear their hearts with pride. Their passion is their people. They want you to love what you do and where you do it. Their employee-driven culture encourages a healthy work-life balance and supportive work environment. They invest in your success and well-being so that you can provide the best care for the patients that they serve. Join the incredible team of EMTs and paramedics in Memphis, Nashville, and across the nation today. Learn more at LifeCareAMB.com.